And everybody else feels the same way about you. We all love you, man.
Just push down in the middle of the street. No. Which means we must follow these basic rules of conduct. Comply with applicable laws, including export control, sanctions, and human trafficking laws. That's a good one.
Bill Clinton.
Yep.
Sorry.
Respect the rights of others, including privacy and intellectual property rights, which means you can't be playing our videos no more.
No.
No. You guys had a chance. The last time they updated the terms of service, you had a chance to be better and change your conduct. But you didn't. You continue to do the reaction channels. You continue to be playing other people's videos and making fun of them. So now Google's going to get involved.
Yeah.
And now you're going to have to respect our rights to make our videos. Yeah. Yeah. It says, don't abuse or harm others or yourself or threaten or encourage such abuse or harm. For example, by misleading, defrauding, defaming,
bullying,
harassing, or stalking others. Oh, no. Oh, no.
A lot of people in violation of this, which is the Google. This is Google.
Which means it's done.
Yeah.
It's done and over. Your days are over.
You're done. Completely.
Yep. It says, don't abuse, harm, interfere with, or disrupt services. Which means, drama channels, you try...
No, it's not.
No, it's not. You'll find out later. So...
Idiot, right off the bat.
Well, whatever.
It's not up for interpretation.
No, it's not. Yes.
You're an idiot.
Oh, they fucking answered me. They did what I told them to do.
Permission to use your content.
Permission to use your content.
No. Oh, my God.
Did you hear that? Permission to use your content, guys. Some of our services are designed to let you upload, submit, store, send, receive, and share your content. You have no obligation to provide any content to our services, and you're free to choose the content that you want to provide. If you choose to upload or share content, please make sure you have necessary rights to do so and that the content is lawful. Now you're going to have to ask us for permission to use our videos now. Let's continue.
License. Your content remains yours, which means that you retain any intellectual property rights that you have in your content. For example, you have intellectual property rights in the creative content you make, such as reviews you write. Or you may have the right to share someone else's creative content if they're giving you their permission. Oh no. Drag, you do not have permission to use any of my videos. Any. So in order to use our content now, this is what Google said. We need your permission if your intellectual property rights restrict our use of your content. You provide Google with that permission through this license.
You know what this means? All this fair use stuff is gone.
Yep, fair use stuff. Yep. What's covered? This license covers your content if that content is protected by intellectual property rights. What's not covered? The license doesn't affect your privacy rights. It's only about your intellectual property rights. This license doesn't cover these types of content. Publicly available factual information that you provide, such as corrections to address or local businesses, that information doesn't require a license because it's considered common knowledge that everyone's free to use. Feedback that you offer, such as suggestions to improve our services, feedback is covered at the service-related communications. Scope. This license is worldwide, which means it's valid anywhere in the world. Non-exclusive, which means you can license your content to others. But you need to license it. Royalty free, which means there are no fees for this license. Rights. This license allows Google to host, produce, distribute, communicate, and use your content. For example, to save your content on systems and make it accessible anywhere you go. Publish, publicly perform, or publicly display your content if you've made it visible to others. Modify and create derivative works based on your content, such as reformatting or translating it. Sublicense these rights to other users, allow the service to work. But that's not the main thing. The main thing is, in order to use someone's video now for your content, you're going to have to get permission.
That's right.
And that's exactly what I asked Google to do, and did it.
And it's not up for interpretation.
And it's not up to, if you want to use my videos, you're going to have to ask my permission.
That's correct.
And the answer to most of the time is no. They're my videos. It's my intellectual property. What type of vitamins are behind me? Oh, these are so awesome. Hey, you can get this at a party, by the way. Ollie Brand. Bedtime Beauty. It's got melatonin, ceramides, and L-theatin. And I'm telling you, this stuff is amazing. You it puts you to sleep, and you wake up, and you're, like, glowing, baby.
That's right.
And it tastes delicious. But, intellectual property, laugh out loud. You know what? You just go away. Go away. What's up? Did you hear the good news? Google's changing its terms of service. Now people are going to have to ask permission to take other people's content. And to use it, just like the news has to. Just like the movie business has to, and any other entertainment business has to. They have to ask permission to use people's videos, or they have to ask if they want to use their likeness. If they, yeah, if someone is on the news and they refuse to be on the news, they have to take you out. I like that they're structuring it like government-issued media services now.
Yeah. Well, Google has to be,
basically. Yeah, so, I don't know. I'm sorry, drama channels. Your day has ended. I mean, see, here's the thing. Google, YouTube, everyone who's not involved in the drama community know that you guys are the most toxic, venomous disruptors out there in content creating. You take content creators, you steal their content, and you mock them and ridicule them, and it takes away from their creativity, and it ruins their self-esteem. And really, your type of channels get people killed, period. You get people to commit suicide all the time. How many people have to commit suicide for you guys to stop doing what you're doing? How many? There's been way too many people committed suicide because of you drama channels. It has to stop. I've wanted to kill myself. I have people watching me right now because of it. So, I'm glad this is happening. You can do SNL style videos about others as long as you don't use their personal videos. Yeah, which is fine. I'm fine with that. Flattery is the best, you know. Yeah, imitation is the best form of flattery, sorry. We're so old. Our brains are going. I went to Target, and then I got to the house, and I collapsed, and I twisted both my ankles, so I'm not doing good. That's what I get for getting out of the house.
Hey, folks, we had some twin burgers at fucking McDonald's.
Can I post the link to the new rules? It's... Just go to Google. It's right there, pink line on top. I mean, just go to google.com. It's right there.
Yeah,
the reaction channels are gone, because you have to get permission in order to use their content now.
Correct.
Oh my god, hello, Shani, watching from Ireland. Well, hello, how is the Green Isle? How is it? I'm very Irish. You want to know my maiden name? Shannon Eileen McGraw. There's nothing more Irish than that name.
No.
Hello, watching from Mozambique. Oh, wow. That's awesome.
What?
Hello.
Oh, Shannon, you got
international. I know, man. I'm a famous boy.
Are you a famous boy?
But yeah, I'm telling, this is going to help so many people feel like they can be comfortable being creative again, you know? And not only that, with the drama channels down, it's gonna calm people the fuck down, so they're not gonna find it necessary to hate on you, and they're gonna be able to calm down and rationally think for and realize, oh wait, you're not as evil as I thought you were. Because these drama channels, what they do is they emotionally manipulate you to think that someone's awful when they're not, they're just human. So, I'm happy about the decision. God bless you, Google. Thank you for helping us more. Because we gotta stop this bullying. We really do. And I find it funny how I messaged them that idea, and now they put it in the Google's Terms of Services. Look down at my Twitter feed. 2 days ago, I gave them that idea to ask permission for people's videos, and now they're putting it in their content now? Wow. Maybe they didn't think of it like I did. Maybe I...
They do now.
Google will always listen to me because I helped create YouTube.
All drama channels, Draymond, no jobby, still
Yeah, if you like it or not, I helped create YouTube. I helped create the algorithm, so.
They know I'm sure they know you've been at this. They know your name.
Right? They know who I am.
You're
I am a part of the history of Google.
Did you show them this?
Oh, we got some really-
Did you show them that?
Look at this. I got a game.
Yeah.
In the Bob Ross game, happy little accident. So what you do in this game is you make like little, like, what they call it, whimsical squiggles. Whimsical, because, you know, it's Bob Ross. I want to get the Bob Ross video game, actually.
I do.
And then you get these cards, and then you can transform the pictures into what you want from the cards. And then you can vote who's the winner. Got some other games that I actually want to be playing with the audience because I think it'll be fun.
Yeah, that would be cool.
Most reaction channels are leeches. Yes, they are.
That's correct.
Yes, they are. And I'm glad that you need permission now in order to take someone's video.
Amen. Amen.
You know what it was? I think it was all the content creators complaining about these reaction channels because they hit everyone.
I know.
Everyone. And really, oh my god, Charlie Gold just... Charlie, what are you going to do, girl? What are you gonna do, Life of the Free Spirit? What are you gonna do, girls?
I can't do that to us yet again.
You can't rely on your own selves in order to get views like that.
I know. You do.
I do. I'm sorry. Okay, so anyway.
I'm sorry.
I got Never Have I Ever. I got that one. This is fun. Have you ever played Never Have I Ever? Hilarious. And then I got this. This is really fun. Okay. This is called Utter Nonsense. So basically, it has like these cards where it can tell you what accent you want, like redneck or like capitalist or something bullshit like that. And then you can choose between, and then you take different cards and you say silly phrases like in the accent. And I guess, yeah. It's basically a conversation starter type of game. I got that one. And then this one, I know you guys are gonna love this. Is it true you started an After Dark series? Yeah, we have. We should be doing the After Dark tonight. So. What? Yeah, people like our After Dark series.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay, so.
Alright.
I got this one. Hello, 90s trivia game.
Hello.
How could you not love this? And it's just a bunch of 90s trivia and stuff. And it also has like these cards where it just does a frame like Seinfeld lines, and you go back and forth with Seinfeld lines. Do this dare and keep this card. Send an email to your boss.
So you don't know how copyright system works, you idiot. For clarity, this license does not grant any rights or permissions for a user to make use of your content independent of the server.
Send an email to your boss or teacher asking how their weekend. Relax.
It says on my Facebook that.
Seems in particularly high spirits today. God. You know, you guys don't understand me. When I'm high, they think I'm sober. When I'm sober, they think I'm high.
Yeah. Whatever.
Listen, you son of a bitches. I wish I was like high on freaking like weed or something, but I'm not. I'm not.
Clearly, you don't know how copyright system works, you idiot. For clarity, this license does not grant any rights or permissions for a user to make use of your content independent of the service.
They're protecting your copyright on their services, which is YouTube and basically almost everything else. Okay?
Like, why would you go to someone with such vitriol, like disrespect like that, Firebomb 12?
Ban them. All these people are gonna have to just die on the internet.
I mean, how is that productive to conversation by calling someone an idiot and think that I would read the rest of it?
Okay, there. I've already called you. Okay.
Yeah. Well. Come on, some people just glow naturally. You glow when you're high?
You glow all the time.
This is gonna get difficult as time goes by. They're gonna see more and more of it.
I know.
Have you Christians noticed that you're getting your glorified bodies and you're slowly transforming yet? You wonder why I'm glowing? I'm gonna be glowing a lot more soon, trust me. I'm low. I think high spirits as just being in a good mood. Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
I'm low, I have depression. Shani cheers me up. Oh, I wanna cheer you up, baby. I don't want you to be in depression. Depression sucks.
Shani cheers me up, there you go.
I like that. I cheer someone up. No, I got this for my son.
Yeah, this is great.
I got this for him.
That's really cool.
It's so cute.
That's really cool.
It's so cute. I saw it and I was like, oh my gosh, this is, maybe I'm pregnant. Everyone's saying I'm glowing lately. Am I pregnant? Did you knock me up?
I hope so. I want to have a baby with you, so I hope so. I mean that.
I'm old.
I asked Jesus to open your womb to have another child. I want to have a biological child with you.
Baby.
I mean, Will and Zach are good enough. I consider them mine now. But I would like a biological child. I would.
Baby.
One. Just
baby.
One. Yeah.
You know, I'm just going to have to put in my little codes the word Japan. A banned word.
Okay.
You really find that in Japan?
Yep. Yeah, That's in Japan.
Do you think everything in Japan is written in Japanese? Well, haiku. Right. Or not haiku, does it matter where I live anyway?
No, it doesn't. Japan kicks ass.
I'll say that. I know. Why are you so obsessed with where I live, bros? Why you want to find me?
Maybe Google should know about that.
Why you want to find me? Are you a stalker?
Oh, yeah. Everybody should go watch TJ Kirk, the Amazing Atheist News video on his latest on his old channel.
Oh, laugh out loud. You're going full Von Helton. You never. How am I going Von Helton?
Motherfucker. Don't make me get my shotgun. Go out there and hunt those aliens.
I remember that one time where Von was like, he looked out the window. He's like, he grabbed a gun and like went out and he was like, oh my god, it's those aliens again.
He was hunting a gray alien. He did.
Yeah, I know.
He hunted a gray alien.
Yeah. No one is like Von. Leave Von alone. Yeah, Von is a motherfucking original and an OG motherfucking YouTuber. Leave Von alone. You know, Von has been around on social media for so long that he needs fucking respect, dude.
I respect him.
Like, I'm sorry what happened to him those months ago. Like, I let all those freaking detractors come in my room. I didn't know what was going on.
He blamed me for it.
Yeah.
I thought you were my friend, man.
Later, Christina. Sorry.
He's like, I don't know Shandy for grasping nothing, really. But I know you, Rev, and you let those haters in. I wasn't home, Von. I was getting the kids from school.
I had no idea Von had a hater group like that.
I know you don't know him well. I do. I hung out with him.
Well, it's just that.
He shouldn't have blamed you or me.
Well, it's just I don't like getting myself self-involved in drama, and I don't like mean people, so yeah, I don't watch mean people.
I know. And that's a good thing.
Maybe it's the fact that you're paying in one of the most expensive cities and one of the most mossy ratio.
That's actually correct.
Yeah, get off my channel, dude.
We can afford it. Haha, loser.
Leave me alone.
Bye.
You are not welcome here. You are mean. John P. Drama is leading cause of drama, exactly.
Ha.
I like your icon of the Star Wars.
Star Wars.
Ooh, that's been soon. Wait.
Christmas.
Wait.
No, we already saw
wait.
It.
There's another Skywalker. Star. Yeah. No, there's another Star Wars movie. They did Solo. They did the Yoda. What else were they gonna do? I think they're doing Boba Fett.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's it, Boba Fett.
Mandalorian's on Netflix, man. That's Boba Fett, really.
Oh, maybe they just combined everything. It was like, no, here, Baby Yoda, and
Yoda.
What Star Wars has done, they just was like,
yeah, they're pretty much done for now.
Let's not put any more cash cows out.
Well, you can look up Shannon if you want to. You can look up Star Wars. I think there's going on Luke. I think. That would be your shit. Who are they going to get to play Luke Young?
Mark Hamill.
I'm almost done.
You know who would make a good Luke Skywalker?
Who?
Ben Foster.
Me.
Ben Foster.
Oh, Ben Foster, me. Oh, look at this shit. This is fucking epic, man. This is fucking epic. I'm getting fucking
pissed. Yeah, show.
Fucking
shit. Yeah.
All right.
That's angry.
I'll do. I can do Luke, man. I could. All right. I don't have much left to lose. So I'll do Luke. I ain't no actor, but I can play Luke.
My Moogle sitting on a donut.
This Starbucks cold brew. Damn.
I love the movie Mean Girls, but I don't. You are sexy, baby. Right now, man. Feels bad about himself, and I'm like, no, baby, you're sexy. Later.
I want to look pretty.
Okay. Well, we have a gym, we have a pool,
yeah.
We have a sauna,
yeah.
We have a hot tub.
Yeah.
You better work, bitch.
You better work, bitch.
I've witnessed people on live streams have mental. Well. We have a gym, we have a pool,
yeah.
We have a sauna,
yeah.
We have a hot tub.
Yeah.
You better work, bitch. You better work, bitch.
Exactly.
I've witnessed people on live streams have mental breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen of that.
Yeah,
daily. There's gotta be at least one good cry in a live daily. Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen of that.
Yeah.
Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen of that. Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
Breakdowns.
Oh.
Breakdowns.
Oh.
Breakdowns. 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 Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen. Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen of that.
Yeah, okay.
Breakdowns.
Oh, yeah.
I'm queen of that.
Yeah, okay.
That happens on like the daily. There's got to be at least one good cry in a live stream, or it's not a good live stream from Shandy for Christ.
Yeah, that's correct.
I'm sorry. I mean, just in general, it's okay, John. It's okay. The nature of my emotional being. Will you share a name of that body oil spray again, Shani?
Yeah.
Sol de Janeiro. Sol de Janeiro.
I have a body oil spray.
Oh.
But I got about it. It's glorious. Okay, honeybee. They are watching us right now. Of course, they have no lives. But that's okay. It's soon they won't be able to do that. I quite enjoy a lot of drama channels. I can't enjoy them. I just see mean-spiritedness in them, and it's just like, I think the one drama channel, and I wouldn't even say it's much of a drama channel anymore, is Rich Lux.
And Peter Mon,
yeah. Peter Mon isn't much of a drama channel.
He is.
Well,
oh, come on.
Yeah, but he's not cruel. He doesn't use other people's content.
He's not mean, but he's a
yeah, he just, I wouldn't say drama. I say he's a gossip channel.
That's kind of the same thing.
I don't know.
But he's nice about it.
But
I like him.
I know.
And he doesn't steal content. He just goes on to introduce himself. He's
I like that idea, John. It would be nice for big companies such as YouTube and Google to offer support chat.
Yes,
I still watch Coughlin too. He's a cutie patootie.
Actually, I guess it works out better. When you talk to Google and they don't know YouTube for shit.
Yeah, you're right, Faith. That's comedy rather than drama. Petermon is comedy.
Yeah, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's his own material, so it's his own content. You know, I don't have a problem people talking about me, but when they're using my content and breaking it down in these fractional moments just to try to, I guess, get to you,
yeah.
And they twist words by going moment to moment, so it's really easy to brainwash people into thinking that what that person in the drama channel is saying, because they're taking what someone's saying out of context, always out of context, and twisting it in a negative connotation.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have a problem people talking about me, but when they're using my content and breaking it down in these fractional moments just to try to, I guess, get to you,
yeah.
And they twist words by going moment to moment, so it's really easy to brainwash people into thinking that what that person in the drama channel is saying, because they're taking what someone's saying out of context, always out of context, and twisting it in a negative connotation. Yeah, some of these reaction channels go too far. That would be Charlie Bull, Life of a Free Spirit, and then there's other reaction channels that they just play the video and they just sit there and don't say a damn thing. So they're basically stealing this person's content with their face in front of it.
Yeah.
And gain monetary gain for it. I don't think anyone should be able to get money to make fun of others.
I don't either.
But Charlie Gold, she's done. She's done. She tried to make videos about herself.
Yeah.
Every time she makes something about herself, she 2,000 views compared to the 88,000 she usually gets.
Yeah, so I can't do this content.
No, she can't rely on her own self for content.
We can.
Yep, because I have a personality.
That's right, exactly, we do.
Don't, don't you like my personality?
You mean that right
here. Try to make videos about herself.
Yeah.
Every time she makes something about herself, she 2,000 views compared to the 88,000 she usually gets.
Yeah, so I can't do this content.
No, she can't rely on her own self for content.
We can.
Yep, because I have a personality.
That's right, exactly, we do.
Don't you like my personality?
Mean that.
Personality.
That's right, exactly, we do.
Don't you like my personality?
Mean that.
Personality.
That's right, exactly, we do.
Don't you like my personality?
Mean that.
Personality.
That's right, exactly, we do.
Don't you like my personality?
Mean that right there. Mean that shit. Okay, we'll get the voice. Be right back, buddy.
Charlie, oh, truthfully, Trisha was on. Oh, hi, baby. I'll see you in a minute.
I love you.
I love you. I've never seen Truthfully Trisha. I've heard all about her, but yeah, she's a queen. I don't know anything about her. I don't got time for that. Never Tuesday, I found that YouTube has just inundated with these reaction videos. I once looked up YouTube personality and there were hundreds of reaction videos just on that one YouTuber. It's nuts. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It's just like, I don't understand why these people are. So little in their confidence in themselves where they can't rely on themselves to put out content, and why they have to use such dishonest manners to get content. That's what bothers me most. It really is. I don't like that person. They're weird. Anyway. Why are people so mean? I truly wonder. So, anyway. I know, I came across a dumbass video about Shani, so I came to see for myself that I did. Thank you, Never Tuesday. Thank you. Yeah, it's just like, it's like so childish, these reaction channels do. So childish. It's like, come on, guys. You don't like them. I get it. Move on with your life. Do something else. Do something positive. Why are you gonna, if someone's doing bad and feeling bad and stuff, why are you gonna kick them? I don't get that. You know, I don't like rude people, I guess. But trolls are fine. I can handle that. But trolls are fine. I can handle that. I can handle trolls. Random trolling, I'm fine with, because it's just stupid. But I can't wait for this, and you're gonna have permission to use someone's video. I think what it is, I think they have to do this because there's been so many DMCA claims from other content creators because of these drama channels that they have to. Register for G-Man Exercise channel. He still has that channel. Yeah, they push you, and this is what they do to content creators, these drama channels. They push and push and push and push. And when the person finally reacts, oh, I told you about them. Look how horrible of a human being they are. So horrible. I can't believe they would even say that to me. How dare they say that to me? How can you tell me I'm a bully? I want better for you. Don't you know that? I want better for you. So why don't you take your 10-sized underwear and go somewhere else? Because I am a good person, and I'm going to continue to do videos about you even though you told me not to. And I don't care because I'm getting the coin. That's their mentality, it seems. Tell me I'm a bully. I want better for you. Don't you know that? I want better for you, so why don't you take your 10-sized underwear and go somewhere else? Because I am a good person, and I'm going to continue to do videos about you even though you told me not to. And I don't care, because I'm getting the coin. That's their mentality, it seems. You're literally just guessing.
And he said he was going to make it a part of new broadcast workouts.
Well, G-Man, you put out your workout videos, I'll put out my workout videos. On OnlyFans.com/ShannyForChrist. Can't you just ignore those response videos? It would be lovely to be able to ignore the response videos, but see, here's the problem with that. You can't ignore these response videos or these reaction channels. You know why? Because they have a horde of demons that come after you. Every video they make, they send a horde of demons at you to tell them they made a video about you because they need a reaction from you so they have something to talk about. So, no, you can't ignore them because they just don't go away. They're like roaches. You shine a little light on them, though, and they scatter. Thank you, Drip and Sniz. And you can't ignore that as well. Are you purposely trying to be antagonistic down south? Answer that question. Are you purposely trying to be antagonistic? Some of them encourage people to be mean, though. Exactly. Seems would be easy to... Oh, yeah, you're there to antagonize. Sorry. I am 36 years old and I'm perimenopausal. I do not have the energy or mental capacity to handle your bullshit right now. I'm 37. You do you, babe. Love it. Thank you. Thank you. You know, you can tell, like, if you're planning on going to social media, you can tell when someone's being antagonizing or if someone's really legitimately being kind. Usually the antagonizing ones, they ask these questions. They're not mean per se, but they're little annoying questions meant to antagonize you and pick you apart and kind of manipulate your brain chemistry to frustration. Like, why would you nitpick someone like that? I gave you a fucking answer, dude. If you don't like my answer, fuck off. I'm not gonna go and admit to your twisted view of my reality. Sorry, your delusions are your delusions, and what you think of me are your problem, not mine. But I'm certainly not gonna admit to your delusions about me. Jeez, man, 44. Aw, beautiful, 47. See, we're all old bags here. You get it. You know, we're old. We're all falling apart at the seams. We're tired of men. And we just want our goddamn peace and quiet. It's about me. Jeez, man, 44. Aw, beautiful, 47. See, we're all old bags here. You get it. You know, we're old. We're all falling apart at the seams. We're tired of men. And we just want our goddamn peace and quiet. And we just want our goddamn... You get it? You know, we're old. We're all falling apart at the seams. We're tired of men. And we just want our goddamn peace and quiet. I mean... Hello, Karen. Rachel, 48. God, man! That's beautiful, your ages. I think 40 is like the greatest age. Like, being in your 40s is like the top age for a woman. Because a woman in their 40s, they know who they are. They know what they want, and they don't take no for an answer. I love that. It's so strong and raw. but yeah, I'm gonna get going, though. I actually want to play some Kingdom Hearts. I'm jonesing for that. Where is it? Did you take that from me? And I'm so excited to play it on my channel, Cuzzy Kakarot. So I'm excited about that. I'm bi. True that. You're a gay. Gays are welcome, dude. You can be gay. I'm bi. True that. You're a gay. Gays are welcome, dude. You can be gay. I'm bi. I only started leaking last year. That's all I'm gonna say about my age. Yeah. That sucks. Okay, I'm gonna gross out the guys, but women who have perimenopause and going through menopause knows this. We have problems with containing our bladders, and sometimes we piss ourselves a little bit. A wee bit. That's why we get panty liners and shit like that, because you do. And it happens with, I think how they explained it, it happens with perimenopause because the estrogen is weakening and it kind of like weakens the muscles within your bladder. So if you sneeze or cough, you're probably gonna pee yourself a little bit, a wee bit. It's just what happens to us. It sucks. Last night, lady gave me the middle finger. What'd you do, John? What'd you do? I do that every time I sneeze, and I'm 26. Childbirth did my... Oh, my God. William. My oldest did that. It's like... He was a 10-pound baby, though. There is that. I had a 10-pound baby. So... It was so... I remember it was really bad at the beginning. Right after I gave birth, I had no bladder control. Completely incontinent. And I remember William... We just went to the hospital, literally. But we had to go to William to his baby appointment for his checkup, because he had a little bit of jaundice when he was born. So I remember being in the parking lot. We just finished the doctor appointment. I'm like, literally, I just felt the urge. I was like, wow, honey, I'm gonna have to go back inside. I gotta pee. And I just pissed all over myself right in the parking lot of the doctor's office. With no control, I felt was the urge to pee, and then I was peeing. And that took a lot of Kegels, about 2 years of Kegels, of Kegel exercises, for my bladder to be at least strong enough not to piss itself. I can hold my bladder now, thank God. But right after giving birth to my first son, nope. I'm trying to get my cat welcome. Also with you, Drippin' Sniz. Yeah, 10 pounds. But he's, oh my gosh.
He's becoming such a man. He's gonna be taller than me soon, my oldest. He is, like, we gotta take him to the shoe store, actually, because his feet are so big that his feet are pretty much pinned, his toes are pinching in his feet, and he's like, right here with me now. My baby is this tall. He's, like, right here to me. My baby. And he keeps growing, and the boys, they're... I can't keep food in the house. They eat everything, and we're... Everything. And Zachary, he's going through a growth spurt, too. Both of my sons, both huge growth spurts at the same time, so... Food is non-existent in this house. Sadly, Mom, I'm hungry. What do we got to eat? Oh, Lord. And I'm tall. I'm 5'9". My dad is 6'4". So... And their biological father, Douglas, he was 6'5". So difficult to converse with 500 people watching live stream. Total subscriber at John P. Check. 10-pound baby Jeebus, mine was 6. Huh, yep, that was me at Walmart last week. And Kegels haven't helped me, and I'm 18 months later, still hoping they help. Have you tried the I know this sounds weird, but have you tried the Kegel balls? That you can get, like, at sex shops? They're basically, you can get them either in, silicone or metal, but and what you do is you just insert them up in you and just, you know, do your Kegel exercises, you know, and it's meant to strengthen the, your vaginal walls, I guess, and bring back that muscle. So, a little hint, if you need to strengthen them more, I suggest some Kegel balls. They help, and also, there's also the after effect that's really, really tiny, but there's that. We're talking about getting yourself strong enough so you don't lose your freaking bladder anymore. The trolls can, yeah, that's ours. We'll shut it down. No more crumbs for the meanies. No. No, it just comes to the point where you need to take back control of your channel, and you have to be like, no. I can't spend the rest of my life arguing with people who just want to condemn me, and I don't think anyone should spend the rest of their life trying to communicate with people who just want to condemn you, because it doesn't matter what you say or what you do. They're just gonna continue to condemn you. You could be walking your dog, right, in a park, and you're just like, stop, don't run, like that, to your dog. And they'll be like, animal abuse, you're abusing your animal. You could be laughing, and they accuse you of, like, doing drugs. You could be, like, having your hair like mine, and I'm sure they probably already said it. Why is your hair so greasy? Because I use this stuff. I'm taking care of myself, and my skin, and my body. Like, my dinner is this, cheese whips. And, tomatoes. That's what I wanted. Because I'm like, lately, I've been, like, really, I'm probably, like, my diet is probably 70% raw now. But I like having the milk and, you know, a little bit of fish every one. But I mean, a lot better. Like, these pants are falling off of me right now because I've lost so much weight. Person can't read everyone's comments and questions. If you have too many viewers, then disable chat. No, if I have too many viewers, I'd probably just let them chat amongst themselves, and every once in a while I'll just look at the chat and just let them and just answer that. 28 people are not happy I'm here. But I'm not afraid of them. I'm not. You know, they're just a bunch of immature human beings who have nothing better to do with their life, and they think the best thing to do with their life is making fun of the others, because it's being in that lifestyle, it is kind of validating because you get laughs and attention, and, you know, but it's like, what kind of attention do you really want, guys? Do you really want to be known for the person who bashes others that are different? Do you really want to be known for that? Or would you want to be known for, you know, trying to help others out and communicating with them and loving them, regardless of their differences? I don't know. I'd rather be known for love than for hate. And I don't want to do hate on others. I don't even want to hate on the people, because I can't do it anymore. I mean, you're expecting hate, and it's like, I don't got any in me. You hated me out. You hated me so much that me even thinking about hating on another person is despicable for my own character. It's just like, ew. It's just complete repulsion. Hate. You know? Help others. I can't find too many channels like that. No, but you will soon because of this change of service. You will soon. You know, things are going to calm down a lot more on YouTube. It's not going to be as dangerous as it has been mentally for people because... You know, I need to know this, and I need my fans to help protect me at this point, okay? I'm gonna ask you fans to do something, and if you see any harassment, please report it. Please report it. Any cyberbullying regarding me, or anyone, really, report it. Because us not reporting these things, and us not putting this aware on YouTube, they're not gonna stop. They're just gonna continue. They have gotten me to the point in my life where I have to ask people to please stop trying to push my buttons, okay? I have a psychological disorder called borderline personality disorder, and it can cause a, and thank God I've had therapy because I can recognize this about myself, but I'm afraid of myself, okay? One of the things that happens within my psyche, because I am a trauma victim to a lot of trauma, and one of the things that happens when I'm, like, really, 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 really pushed, and I can feel it coming, and I'm afraid for myself and my own safety on my own regard, okay? Because I don't know when it's coming, but I know it's going to come, because I feel the building up of it. And if you're borderline, you know what I'm talking about. You're pushing me to the point where you possibly could get me to the point where I black out and kill myself. You need to stop this, because it's coming to the point where I'm not going to be able to control my own self, okay? Because of all the trauma I took, it does happen to people where they black out and do things that they don't remember, but it's a defense mechanism, and I feel like it's coming, and I don't want to hurt myself. I've done it too much in my lifetime, and I don't want to hurt myself. You know, I even called like CPS and stuff to tell them this stuff today, because I don't want to hurt myself. I don't want to get to that point where I black out and do something horrible to myself. And you can go and say, oh, she's playing the victim. I'm not. I'm telling you, I know the nature of this fucking disorder. And I know you're pushing me to that point. You know, this harassment has to end. There's got to be a point where you think, is this a good thing for me to do? Because I haven't done anything. All these people that you're listening to, they're lying to you about me. They don't know me. They don't know anything about me. They just look at a couple things and they're like, oh, she's awful. Without even getting the whole story, without even knowing the whole story, without even asking me the whole story. None of them asked what happened. None of them asked anything. They just assumed what happened. And you can't get any clear information off a police report of what actually happened, to tell you the truth. Because all the police report is doing is taking one side and reporting it, and another side and reporting it, and what they think happened reported it. And that's not... And trying to validate someone's guilt or innocence over a police report is completely against our legal system of how it works. Do you even know how it is to go into court and how it fucking works? You know? You fucking idiots. You know it's innocent before proven guilty. It's not guilty before proven innocent. But for some reason, you guys think it's okay to presume someone guilty before proven innocent. What kind of freaking people are you? Aren't you Americans? I have stepped back from the internet before, and they continue to do it too. They give us personal phone calls. That one last break I took where I said I'm quitting YouTube, they were still calling CPS and authorities on us. They were still trying to, they were calling and found our phone numbers, and they were calling us on our phone and harassing us. It doesn't matter what I do, where I go, if I take a break, if anything, they're gonna still harass me. And the pictures, the people who take pictures of me is so fucking crazy. I don't even like going out of the house anymore. People following you with cameras, like a fucking paparazzi. It's fucking awful. You know, I don't know why people think this is okay to do to someone. Stop playing fucking vigilantes. Stop. You're not a fucking vigilante. You're not a fucking hero. All you're doing is you're taking the system and using it to abuse. And you're wasting money and time from people who could use it. But no, I'm not gonna step away, because that's what they want. That's how they win, is when you're silent and they're allowed to say whatever they want to say to you. Bash you fucking up and down. No, I'd rather be fucking strong, stand here, and tell you exactly what these people are doing so they can be fucking exposed to the light. So people know what they're doing, and people will start realizing, maybe I am being manipulated by these people. Maybe they don't really know these people. Maybe what they're saying isn't true. Like everyone says, Jason has like these felony charges on him. There's no felony charges on him.
No.
That's a lie.
What you said yesterday, Shannon, we're just waiting for the cases to be dismissed by a judge. We're not going to jail. There's not even any fines. We're just waiting to have a dismissal. That's it. And then we move on to civil. We get our money.
Yeah. It's a mob mentality. It is a disgusting mentality to have, and it needs to stop. And if I have to sit here and fucking be on my soapbox and freaking say it, there are people harassing me. There are people harassing me. They're harassing me. They're using authorities to harass me. YouTube, are you gonna fucking do something?
You have to stop yelling like that.
I'm sorry.
Okay, but it's not okay with some people, probably. Okay? You can't be rough with that.
look at this little excuse here, but does being a public personality give you more good consequences than bad? Does it give people the right to harass me? And why should I be blamed for the harassment? Why should I be the one responsible for grown adults harassing other grown adults and doing horrible things and breaking laws and putting false police reports out on them? I'm supposed to be responsible for that. I'm supposed to just leave everything behind because of that and let them win. Of these people, because they didn't only come for me. They come for a lot of people, And you guys really need, and YouTube needs to know of Kiwi Farms. YouTube, everyone needs to be aware that there is a place called Kiwi Farms where they dock drop people. They harass people. They get involved in authorities with people. And, talking and talking and talking and telling everyone what you are doing. Yeah, that's why Von, when Von had all this trouble, you know, people called him crazy because he called these people terrorists.
They are.
It's true, they are.
Yeah, and you don't want their teeth to sink in you because they will do it to you too.
And they poison.
Yeah, they will do it to you.
They're snakes. They're literally.
And I'm so sorry for my fans. I'm so sorry that you can't. Yeah. I would love to have the opportunity to be able to just sit in a room with you guys and talk to you guys and have fun and be able to be fucking free.
Yeah.
I want that. I just don't know how to do it. Because there's really fucked up people there out there that really want to go and try to push this issue that I'm this unfit drug using mother, fibromyalgia and arthritis, who's always in pain. It's passed thrown up in my face. I can't heal if I'm constantly being told to kill myself. I can't heal. Ever going to be better if you won't let me heal? How am I ever going to become a better person if you keep trying to kick me down and trying to set me up into things? But I've apologized over and over again. Every time I do something bad, I apologize for it. But it's not good enough for these people. Apologies isn't good enough for these people. Saying sorry isn't good enough. I still have to live with it over and over again and have people tell people how much of an awful person I am, and I haven't done anything, and I was found innocent in the court of law. Saying sorry isn't good enough. I still have to live with it over and over again and have people tell people how much of an awful person I am, and I haven't done anything, and I was found innocent in the court of law. What they saw was a woman who is under mental distress that needs therapy and help and healing. That's what they found. There's no domestic abuse case open anymore. It's closed. It's done. We've already gone to court over it.
Yeah,
it was closed on August... August 16th?
Yeah.
It was over August 16th. You can ask Agent about that. He was there when it happened. Faith, I have a question. I want you to block anyone that is trying to reveal our location, anyone who talks about CPS, our cases, anyone who tries to be disparaging in the comments. I need my mods to do their job and to just wipe these people out of existence, because none of us need these people here to harass any of us. Because they're not only harassing me, they're harassing my fans, the people who like me, the people who've been there for me. They're harassing. Oh, look, she is such an awful person. She went to jail. A lot of people went to jail in their lifetime. It doesn't mean you're a bad person because you go to jail. It just means sometimes fucked up shit happens.
That thing that happened back in May, that wasn't domestic abuse at all.
It was sex play.
Yes, and I said as much.
Yeah.
I said it's a victim, me. But they still opened the case. They still charged her with third degree assault. Thank you, Faith. You get it, folks. I'm the victim, but the victim doesn't have any rights because the police department has had so many things happen where there's domestic abuse things, they don't do anything, and then, you know, the spouse ends up really beat up or something like that. That's what it is.
Yeah, someone had to go to jail that day. No one should have gone to jail. I called for an ambulance. Mine, I wanted mental health for you. Cold concrete floor, did everyone watch me? Yeah, it's okay for my civil right to be violated, right? It's so funny for you guys. So funny to, you know, kick someone when they're down. It's so funny, isn't it? Like, no one helps me. No one sticks up for me. I'm always alone, doing things alone, and I can't do it anymore. I need help. You know, today I was like, why are you slurring your speech? Are you drunk? It's so mean. It's so mean. It's like, I can't help slurring my speech. I'm in incredible pain right today. I'm having a horrible flare-up. It feels like I have 1,000 knives stabbed in my body. And I didn't put a lot of content out yesterday because I knew the slurring was started. because you get cognitive speech problems with Fyro because of your neurology is fucked up, you know? Can't move, I hurt, I'm stiff, I don't feel good. I haven't felt good in a long time. But it's just like, I'm sick of being labeled as a drug user. I've never taken any drugs. The worst I've ever done was pot, and that's not that bad. Look, she's a perpetual victim. She's faking victimhood. I'm not faking victimhood. I am a victim of harassment. I am a victim of bullying. I am a victim of my docs being dropped. And while Drag and all these fucking people, the geek group, all of them, were complaining about when G-Man dropped docs, they made such a big deal of it, it's okay and funny when mine is. I don't see Drag going out there and telling everyone, making an actual video that says, please stop dropping Shani's docs, this is not cool, I don't condone this. He condones it, he laughs with them, he jokes with them in the room, he's a piece of shit human being. Drag does nothing but want your money. He doesn't care about you, he doesn't care about any of his dragoons.
Rachel said the word man-free, it's gang stalking.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why I'm standing up. That's why I'm saying it. Because you know what? It needs to come to light. These people need to be shined upon. And I hope one of the bigger YouTubers see it. I hope Shane Dawson sees this. I hope Trisha Paytas sees this. Because you know what? I think the only thing that could stop this internet cyberbullying is probably Shane Dawson. He's got the biggest influence to do it. He could do it. I'm not big enough to expose these people, and I wish I could. And if any of you guys could, like, reach out to them or reach out to someone or, you know, report these fucking videos where they're harassing people and bullying people and making fun of people, now you can go and report them for harassment and bullying. You can. It's in the features now. But YouTube isn't going to take these channels seriously if it's not numbers coming to these other channels and flagging them and reporting them. Because, yeah, we don't want to be known as flaggers. I don't like flagging. I don't like reporting. But it's there because of abuse. And if these people are abusing the system, we have to use the system to stop them. And the only way how to stop them is reporting and talking about it and putting a bigger dialogue on it, because they are internet cyberbullies. Dragnaut and his dragoons are horrible human beings. They really are. And I was a dragoon. I was. And seeing them be so hypocritical and do the fucking things that they got other people over and told they were pieces of shit and tore them up over, and here they are doing the same thing that they were yelling at people over. They became the monster that they were trying to hunt. Be so hypocritical and do the fucking things that they got other people over and told they were pieces of shit and tore them up over, and here they are doing the same thing that they were yelling at people over. I was, and seeing them be so hypocritical and do the fucking things that they got other people over and told they were pieces of shit and tore them up over, and here they are doing the same thing that they were yelling at people over. They became the monster that they were trying to hunt. Thank you, Rachel. But yeah, start reporting these things. You know, I don't know what else to do. This is why I'm asking you. Report them. No, I'm not asking for false flagging. This isn't false flagging. This is real reporting. This is real reporting of harassment and bullying, and we need numbers in order to get this shit done. Okay, I'm tired of the people harassing Amber Lynn and Chantel Marie. I'm tired of people harassing Trisha Paytas. I'm tired of people harassing Nikado Avocado, Nikita Dragon, Jeffree Star. All of us. All of us have been harassed by these people in heavy, horrible numbers. And if we don't report it, if we don't stop them, it's just gonna continue. You know, there's an old adage that says, bad things happen when good men do nothing. It's true. And we are good people, but we aren't doing enough to stop this. And we just have to take that little time out just to click that little flag button and just harassment bullying. It don't take long at all. You know, it's either hit them in their pocketbook or they're not gonna listen. You know, so that's what I'm asking you, is if you see any harassment regarding to me or anyone else, anyone, flag it. Flag it. Because you're doing mankind a service, really, by doing it. And you really are allowing, and if you don't do it, you're enabling them at this point. Like, how long are we gonna let Chantel and Amberlynn be bullied? How long are we gonna allow all these YouTubers be bullied by people who are faceless trolls who don't even know us, any of us? And thank you, Faith. Stay strong. Stick together. Exactly. Exactly. And other than the flag system and actually reporting it. I know you want to be nice and you don't like using the flag because, you know, they're gonna accuse us. Oh, they're starting a flag war. No, this isn't a flag war. This is, you are harassing us and we are tired of the harassment. Okay? You didn't only harass me, you harassed the people who talk to me. That's it in a nutshell. They hide and harass people. No balls at all. Exactly. Exactly. So let's come to an agreement and start fucking flagging these assholes for doing this to us. Because I'm tired of it. I know my fans are tired of it. I know Amberlynn is tired of it. I know Chantel is tired of it. All of us are tired of it. Trisha's tired of it. We're tired. We want respect. We don't want to be treated like animals and... Like, it's not... abusing people on a daily basis and laughing about it and think it's funny and you're justifying it because you listen to these random fucking nobodies on the internet when they tell you about another person. Wouldn't that make you a little, wouldn't that raise you red flags? Seriously. Wouldn't it raise you red flags? Do you really want to be involved with someone who's going to like expose and harass people? Do you really want to be friends? Like, do you really want that? Like, why would you even want to be known for doing stuff like that? Bother you that you're allowing someone to manipulate and to emotionally manipulate you to hate someone? Doesn't that raise red flags that someone is trying to cause you to hate someone? Bother you that you're allowing someone to manipulate and to emotionally manipulate you to hate someone? Doesn't that raise red flags that someone is trying to cause you to hate someone? Doesn't that? You know, because if they're so willing about talking about other people, they'll be very willing to talk about you. I guarantee it. In these rooms, listening to these people talk shit about others, what does that say about you? And then you join in with a shit talk, and you go to other people's channels to harass them, which goes completely against terms and services. So you're breaking terms and services because you don't like someone and you think it's justifiable? And you think you're a good person? You have a moral high ground? I know you're all probably not going to listen to me. I know that. But I'm still going to insert common sense and logic. Because it's completely illogical for grown adults to go in hordes to harass people. The most mature thing to do is if you don't like someone, you don't watch them, you don't linger, you stay in hordes to harass people. It is completely illogical. When most adults, the most mature thing to do is if you don't like someone, you don't watch them, you don't linger, you stay away from them. And I don't go to these drama channels. I don't watch these drama channels. I'm not subscribed to these drama channels, so I don't know what they're being said. And the only reason why I know that something's being said is because they come to me. They come to me. It's like you're talking about yourself. How? Huh? Thank you, Honeybee. Thank you, Honeybee. It's Shane Dawson's conspiracy palette, by the way. What do you want in life? To be happy. To have peace. To be left alone. To be allowed to be happy. To be allowed to be who I am and be free who I am. And not have people tell me I can't be who I am. What do you want in life? To be happy. To have peace. To be left alone. To be allowed to be happy. To be allowed to be who I am and be free who I am. And not have people tell me I can't be who I am. That's what I want. I think it's a pretty simple request, and I think it's something that everyone wants. I can't see some users due to blocking Shani. I'm sorry. I can't see many people either. Well, Rob, Reed, why are you in my... Let me ask you, Rob, why are you subscribed to me then if you don't want people to see my porn page or... Seriously, Rob, don't out yourself like that. I put Shani for Christ in it because I'm known as Shani for Christ. Right. It's shameless labeling and marketing and plugging. Yeah, yeah. That's all.
You can show me awesome friggin' design you did for a wallpaper and stuff.
Man. I'm not subbed by Curious. Oh, it's not Rob Reed. I understand that how important is serving God these days. It's tough for me, but I'm wondering about you and Rev.
In the past, it's not that anymore at all.
Uh-uh.
At all. So yeah, it's very hard serving the Lord with people harassing you. Yeah.
They don't know about our naked Bible studies.
Oh, okay.
What we are attempting to... is basically allowing prostitutes to believe in Jesus and saying it's okay to be a prostitute and believe in Jesus. Because, you know, a man believe in Jesus than a gay man that doesn't believe in Jesus. I'd rather have everyone believe in Jesus. So if I have to be an example, I will.
Do you remember the Bible at all, folks? The people that would criticize us for doing porn? Do you remember he blessed prostitutes? And what you're doing is not prostitution. That's a very specific term.
No, what we offer people is making love on camera. Yeah, like marital love. There's no gentle pornography out there where it's loving and engaging, and it shows people how to love each other through that bond. Yeah. Nowadays, people, their minds are so warped when it comes to sex that they think it's okay to choke and slap and do physical harm to your partner because they claim... I know it's fucking bullshit, but they claim that it's meant to increase sexual pleasure. Now me, I'm in pain 24/7. I am a chronic pain sufferer. I don't see how that could be any near romantic or satisfying at all. So, I provide a service where I show us making love. It is. It's so beautiful. And it shows people that you can make love gently. You can be gentle with your lover. You don't need to be fucking choking them and ramming them up the ass with like a dildo. You know, and there's a big need for that in the porn industry is gentle lovemaking. Not many people do that anymore.
I knew I needed to stop watching porn when I started getting into the fake rape porn, which is so weird. I was getting into that, and I said, no, cut it off. Christ would not approve of any of that. Ever. Rape porn? No. Bad. That's
the Why the whip, then? We only have the whip for 2 weeks.
Oh, my God. Do you realize how... A whip? Really? It wasn't even really whip. It was more of a French tickler than a whip.
It was fuzzy.
Yeah. It was good for, like, doing that on Shannon's body while she's naked. Which, really, nice, right? You remember that, right?
Yeah.
You're getting off and getting tickled with that thing. That was nice. That's what it was for.
Who's that? Oh, lawyers?
Yeah.
All right, I'll be right back.
Live in the center of continents away from great bodies of water that have these stories. I just find it interesting, that's all. I don't know if it's true. I'm not saying it's proof of a flood, but it's pretty interesting.
Okay. People who live in valleys?
Yeah, people that lived within the middle of Southern America, you know, so where the Aztecs built their civilizations, it was great valleys that were difficult to get into.
Yeah, valleys where your sound goes down to.
Are you saying that, okay. that the centers of continent are places where they don't flood? Are you saying that?
I'm not saying that, but if someone made the statement that maybe these people all live by the ocean, and I'm saying that there are people that live away from the sea that still have these stories. I'm not saying that if you live in the center of a continent, you can't be flooded. You know, that would be stupid of me to say that.
Yes, it would.
Yeah. So.
Me and my cousins. Yeah, he won't be there.
Bam. Here.
She's an early riser.
And she might have been busy all night long, huh? It's an exhausting job she has. Gramophone, Daryl Frost. Shame on you. Yet.
Jesus. My daughter is 17, so, and she's been robbed well. So I don't think I'm going to be a granny either. fingers crossed.
This is Lurker. He's never said anything in a little while. You got anything to say, Lurker? Anything really, except for Andy. After last night. And I quite enjoyed our conversation. Where's the mods in here? Is there any mods?
Why do we need
mods? Well, you just might need a mod. You just might. There's people who are taking up space in here, and I might have a crew coming in here that would like to jump in as well. Just to mix things up a little bit, make it more interesting. Lurker's taking a spot and not speaking, so he shouldn't even be in here. He should be going in the waiting room. And same with Stargazer Jim. Have you said anything in the last half hour? That is a no.
Lurk
now it's
fine.
Dead silent. Are you a mod?
Let me check.
Okay, so we do have a mod in here. Great. So, are any of our mics way louder than anybody else? Because that's something that's really annoying. I'm blasting? Okay, I will turn my mic down. Because I don't want to blast anybody's ear. See, I'm a pleasant person. How do I turn my mic down? Because I don't see an option to do so in this server.
Okay, go to your settings.
Oh, yeah, alright. Sure, I can do that. Let me just test here. Okay. Any better?
Still a bit loud.
Did it go down in any?
No.
How about that?
Keep talking. Let's see.
Alright. I don't know if you're gonna trick me, because I know it's on pretty low right now on my machine. So it's gotta be sounding a little quieter now. Don't lie to me.
It sounds the same to me. I don't know. How about you guys?
Maybe you need to turn your volume down.
I did have you turned down like halfway, so but I turned you back up so I could tell if your mic turned down.
Alright, well, maybe you need to adjust your sound then.
Well, it's not just Sassachin.
Let's see what that says. I'm popping? What's that supposed to mean? I'm popping.
Maybe your other settings
are
too high for your mic.
Were you on, XP?
Am I on what?
Were you on XP?
XP?
Atheist experience.
I don't think so.
Okay. You sounded familiar. You're not on Godless Bitches by any chance?
Godless Bitches. I am a godless bitch, if that's what you really want to know.
No, I'm just wondering if...
I'm not a part of any group. I'm my own free agent. I don't belong close-knit to any, what do you call, community, quote-unquote. Been in Pekin.
Right on.
Popping and peeking. I'm told I'm yelling into my mic. Well, if I was yelling, this is yelling! That's yelling. Okay, so really I'm not yelling.
No, because now people
You guys hear the difference, so.
Well, yeah, sure. So anyway.
When people say I'm yelling, I'll demonstrate yelling, and it's considerably different than when I'm talking now.
I think if an admin or if Auntie was in here, she'd be able to actually turn you down.
Mods can too. I have a server as well, and you can turn people down if you give them the powers. When you're not around, Auntie, how about that for a plan?
No, I can mute you. But I'm not gonna do that.
It wouldn't be nice, because I haven't said anything offensive yet.
No.
Then it would be too much like McCrazy in here, right? Yeah. And you don't wanna be that, right? You don't wanna be like that.
Nobody wants to be like that.
No.
Great. Man, we all did.
We're only giving voice chat roles to special people. Yeah, we don't want to do that.
What defines special?
I don't know. You gotta ask him. You're crazy.
Yeah, they got so many definitions for money.
Yeah, why would you bring up fucking S10? Like, to me, he's perfect.
I was doing that as a joke. It's humor a little bit, you know. You guys know what humor is. You haven't lost your sense of humor, have you? Or do you have one?
I got one.
Good.
I don't have one. I decided I lost it. Can't remember when. But yeah, I have.
Oh, maybe it's about time you found some sense of humor. Because, you know, without that, life is pretty goddamn boring. Don't you think?
Innate.
If you make it that way.
Is it innate or nate?
Somebody else join? Is that who you're addressing?
No, I popped in and popped out.
He didn't want to answer that question.
What was the question?
There he is.
Oh, Nate!
Hey, Nate. Is it Nate or innate?
I would say meet Nate.
Because innate is kind of a neat name.
Hello.
Hello.
What up?
Evening. At least till like 3 a.m. That's like 20 a.m.
Try not to get our ears blasted out by fiction.
Just turn your volumes down.
I did.
Out. Listen, I'm gonna mute myself and deafen myself and hear from the outside. See? Really?
Oh boy.
So what's going on?
You know what the problem is, you guys? You got your volume straight up loud. Now you can adjust. If I'm too loud for you, turn it down.
We did. We adjusted.
You know what the problem is? You got your volume straight up loud. Now you can adjust. If I'm too loud for you, turn it down. Oh, here we got some demon music. Is that what that is? There's another YouTuber that likes to play music. And it just suits me. I am trying to figure out how to turn my mic down here. Okay, there it is. Okay, how's that? Is that better? Daryl. Is that down a little bit better, guys?
Sounds fine to me.
There we go. I'm not blasting your earlobes. Eardrums vibrate.
That's good. Yeah, you came in a little hot, though. It's like, whoa.
Yeah, my bad.
I know, you're trying to wake everybody up, so.
Right now, why isn't anybody talking?
Fiction fighter, what is your profile picture?
It's me sucking on a cow's teat, because I love Lala's milk.
Okay.
Lala's milk.
Yeah, I thought that's what it was. I just wasn't sure.
I used to have a Google Plus page, community page, called As Google Plus Churns. And that was my picture, so I kept it. Yeah. Yeah, we love our lost cows. We love our lost cows.
Yeah. I've always wondered, though, why do we drink cow's milk?
Jail scum.
Like, why don't we...
I don't drink cow's milk. I only drink the Lowell's, fresh Lowell's milk.
What is that?
There's a big difference. It's fresh Lowell's cow milk. Do you know what a Lowell's cow is?
No.
I do. Gee, man. Exactly.
There we go.
Okay.
That's one of the oldest Lowell's cows on YouTube.
Would you guys buy breast milk? Like if they sold it in the stores?
Breast milk? No.
Eat my day.
But you would drink a cow's milk, wow.
Oh man, I had so much excess breast milk. Like we were considering making cheese. Like for real. Like it was insane. But anyway, go ahead.
Make cheese from breast milk.
Yeah, you make cheese, yeah. It's your kid. All good.
I don't know, I've been thinking about, like opening a business that sells breast milk. Because I know a lot of bodybuilders and fitness freaks drink breast milk. No, selling it. I'm not going to give it away for free.
No. Like, a lot of women donate it to hospitals and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to try to get free breast milk and then sell it. I just need to figure out how I'm going to do the pricing, right? Like, I've heard Cambodian breast milk is the best in the world, so yeah. I try and source that.
How do you know that?
I don't know. That's like the word on the street.
You know
that? That's a weird word on the street.
Dave Chappelle. Yeah, Dave Chappelle.
I drink only the finest breast milks.
Finest Cambodian breast milks.
Double shots! I'm so cringe, eh? Why don't you come up and give it a try? Let's see how cringe you can get. I've heard you.
Cringe.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yeah.
He's as creepy as you can get.
Come on,
chasing off all our lost cows. You think you're so goddamn smart and witty?
So when have you got, like, responsibilities and stuff tomorrow?
I got work at, like, 10 o'clock. If I'm a night owl.
Alright.
Tell me something, what's the difference between a night owl and a night hawk?
Night owls.
I'm not sure.
Stays up later? I don't know.
I think all owls are technically night owls, right? Like, I've never seen an owl during the daytime.
And a true night hawk is...
Night hawk is what?
Night hawks at the diner, Tom Waits. That's a night
Oh, that was a little too obvious, wasn't it?
Nobody knows. No one knows.
Joe's so smart. He knows that there's a difference between an owl and a hawk.
I want you to see.
No one knows who Tom Waits is, obviously.
What? What did I miss?
Oh, I just put a comment in the stream.
Next. Is that what you put? No, you didn't put that. Because her mic gets too hot.
I tried watching your show from earlier, but it keeps buffering, I said, because your mic is too hot.
Oh, we had a real good time. The last few live streams.
See, what we need is a chicken, a hawk up in here.
Oh, yeah.
Say, boy. Say.
Chicken hawk. Here, boy. Listen up here, boy. So, Jello Shot wants to be a chicken hawk. Are you hearing, boy? Oh,
I hate the silence.
Start a topic.
New topic. Well, you guys are the conversationalists, right? Can't you change topic on man?
I don't know, like, what are you in the mood to talk about?
I'm a fiction fighter. Lie to me. See how that makes you.
Oh, you.
Tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies. Tell me lies, tell me little lies.
Alright, fine. I believe in the fucking noetic flood. Prove me wrong.
Why the hell would you believe that?
My mama told me.
The Bible told you so?
The Bible told me.
You are kidding, right?
Proof for the flood.
Of course I'm kidding.
Like, apparently...
You mean a lie you believe?
I heard apparently, like, there's actual geological proof for the Great Deluge, for, like, the Great Flood. And apparently all ancient civilizations worldwide have a, you know, some story similar to it. That
except for
there
Japan.
Was some great flood.
Japan doesn't have that.
It's not possible to flood the whole world. It's been scientifically proven. The world as they knew it in their small little community at the time, then yes, there was raised waters, but not, you know, as deep as they did, claimed it was. So no, there was no great worldwide flood. There's not enough water in the world to flood the whole world.
Alright, but why would the Aztecs have a flood story? And they're like right in the middle of the continent, you know, they're so far away from the oceans and stuff.
I'm gonna have to call bullshit on you, Nate. Not every society across the world.
Hold on.
It's not a similar flood story. A lot of cultures have a flood story, but they are widely different. I can tell you that where I live, there are major floods every year. So it's not unusual that a lot of places are going to have some sort of a flood story. This is not evidence for the Great Deluge. This is just how geology is. It's just how it is. Places flood. Big deal.
Yeah, cool, but why would they have such a similar narrative to the story of Noah? If you look at any they do. If you look at the Mesoamerican flood myths, it's always a chosen person told to take two animals of each kind onto some ship of some sort.
Citation needed.
All right, hang on. Let me find your citation. Just hang on. Okay.
Definitely citation needed on that one.
I'm sitting here playing Minecraft on Twitch, and then I hear this, you know, bullshit about the flood. I had to pop in. I'm sorry.
Hey, what's
sorry. Oh, you're good. I'm playing Call of Duty right now.
Of course, different cultures have, like,
no,
flood stories.
Xbox. It's not unusual. You're exactly right.
And... of course, they have stories that have, like, the heroine and, like, the hero, and, I mean, that's just humans telling stories. We still tell stories where there's always some sort of hero.
How many societies have it where the universe was birthed by a single woman, or a single man and a single woman came together to birth society? They birthed the... but there were also already people
the
there.
The Greeks, Zeus punished man by making woman.
Yeah. I believe it. That's
one
a fact.
One of my favorite things is like the Greeks.
It's really the other way around, but yeah.
The Greeks. The Greeks.
Hey, that's how the story goes.
No, this like...
Or woman had to be put there to keep the man in check.
Who are we talking about?
I posted the link in the current GDC live chat, that channel. So it talks about the Mesoamerican flood myths. And yeah, I mean, just look into that and you'll see. They all have a flood story. some have it that only a man and his dog survived and then repopulated the earth. I don't know how, you know. They are little variances.
Sodomy's illegal. Sodomy's illegal, dude.
I know, right? Yeah, there are little variances, you know. But they all genuinely seem to be the same, you know. Some god was trying to clean the earth of sin. I just find it very interesting that people halfway across the world would have the same stories.
This is exactly what I would expect to see if local areas flooded and people had fucking myths about shit.
Except for Japan. Japan doesn't have those flood stories.
No, they don't, no. They've got...
They're like, fuck water.
Jeez. But no, seriously, like, Kronos. That's one of my favorite fucking flood... Or not flood stories, but like creation stories. How Kronos fucking like pulled these things from his brain and then bottom it and vomited them out. That was the gods of, you know what I mean? So,
yeah.
But yeah. Japan.
Oh, there's even the Jesus story was,
Okay, I just posted another link which lists all of the ancient civilizations that have had flood stories, and it's almost the whole world. India, Europe, the Middle East,
almost.
China, the Far East, Mesoamerica, North America, Africa.
Yeah, but do they... Wait, okay, so you're saying all of these world flood stories have a family that saves animals?
It's kind of different. Some say it's a family, some say it's one individual, some say it's an individual and a specific set of animals, some say it's like Noah that saved every single type of animal. You know, it changes a little bit. But the premise is generally the same. God wanted to wash the world of sin, had his chosen person or group of people, and maybe they're the only ones that survived the flood.
Yeah, but no scholars.
Let me ask you a question.
Sort of like, yeah.
If you lived in a semi-isolated region, it doesn't even have to be isolated, just like you have a local area, right? A small couple of villages, and you live in a plain, and your plain floods. So your entire quote-unquote world, everything around you is flooded.
Yes.
And only two or three families survive or something along those lines or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Are you not going to write about it? Be like, oh my god, the entire world was flooded, at least from your perspective?
Yeah, I would definitely write. I mean, that is the tale I would tell. Definitely, you're 100% right. But we don't know that that's what happened. But if that is what happened, then it does make logical sense.
Many times.
I don't know, but if we know that's what happened, man. I mean,
we know that's what happened. For many of them, we do know that's what happened.
I don't think so.
Well, we certainly don't know that it was a flood.
I'm not out here saying the flood is true. It's a true story. I'm just saying that I find it very interesting that a lot of ancient civilizations around the world have it within their mythology that there was some, you know,
you can also say that about the Jesus story.
Yeah. I'm
is
not
it really mythology,
that he did it.
Or is it just how they track their history?
It seems to be mythology.
Or is it just the fact that, like, it's these people who live on water have these fucking stories?
But it's people that also live in the center of continents away from great bodies of water that have these stories. I just find it interesting, that's all. I don't know if it's true. I'm not saying it's proof of a flood, but it's pretty interesting.
Okay. So where,
like
so,
people who live in valleys?
Yeah, people that lived within the middle of Southern America, you know. So where the Aztecs built their civilizations, it was great valleys that were difficult to get into.
Yeah, valleys where it only goes down to.
Are you saying that, the centers of continents are places where they don't flood? Are you saying
I'm
that?
I'm not saying
what
that. I'm not saying that. But
flood.
Someone made the statement that maybe these people all live by the ocean. And I'm saying that there are people that lived away from the sea that still have these stories. I'm not saying that if you live in the center of a continent, you can't be flooded. You know, that would be stupid of me to say that.
Yes, it would.
Yeah.
So, but that's the thing. I mean, like, that is really the thing. It's like, there are those cultures, but then there are the hundreds of thousands other cultures who don't have flood myths, you know, like, you know what I mean? Like, so, what
Very
is that?
True.
What does that mean? So, like, culture,
I don't know,
the story of the, Joseph Campbell, let's just get Joseph Campbell to, you know, Exactly. But, you know, like, cultures that don't have floodness. What about them? What, so they don't have any relevance? In...
I don't know about cultures that don't have a floodness. Because it seems the flood would be, toward, you know, it would be part of mythology. Because it seems to have happened a very long time ago. You know, if you look at the flood myth within Greek mythology, it happened... You know how in Greek mythology there are different stages of human civilization? You had the Bronze Age, the Golden Age, wada wada wada. So it seems the flood happened...
Bronze, silver,
when the first...
and gold.
Yeah. So it seems the flood happened when the first iteration of mankind came about, and that version of man is apparently not the same version as we are. So it seems all of these flood stories happened a very long time ago, and they form a part of mythology, not necessarily a part of modern history, you know? So it would be a part of Greek mythology, but you wouldn't find a Roman mythology story for it, for example, you know?
And the key word here is mythology.
Yeah. It's a myth. It seems to be a myth. I just find it interesting that a lot of civilizations from very different parts of the world share the same myth.
You also see...
they're not the same myth. That's the fucking... Great, that's, giant... That's the red herring. No. That's the red herring. It's not the same myth. If you actually study cultures who have a different flood stories, it's not the same.
But I've looked into it, you know, and from what I've seen, as I said, there are little nuances, small changes, but the general premise is the same. God trying to get rid of sin and having a select person or group of people as the only survivors of this great flood. That's generally what happens in all of the stories.
Fair enough.
This is literally what you would expect for a planet that's geologically active. A planet that floods. You'd expect cultures to invent myth stories, flood stories around floods. They invent stories around volcanoes. They invent stories around all of the natural disasters they see. This is not
true.
In any
Very
way
true.
Unexpected.
Very it's true.
Exactly what we see.
But there doesn't seem to be a globe-wide shared common volcano myth story. You know what I'm saying? The flood story is very specific. It's one of the few that a lot of civilizations share. It would be the flood story and maybe the creation story. You know, man creating two men, a man and a woman first, blah, 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 blah. Those seem to be the ones you tend to find everywhere. And then some say...
Maybe because those are the most common occurrences in human existence.
Maybe.
Men and women. You have people.
Yeah.
You have bodies of water. Or if you're in a valley, you have a valley that floods.
Yeah, it's possible.
Maybe it's just common experience, but nothing to do with a deity.
You also have landslides quite often, which are often accompanied by either a great rainstorm or a, but they're very similar.
Yeah. I mean, anything is possible. I don't know if we'll ever know what the truth behind all of it is.
I reject that premise. I don't agree that anything
is
possible.
Wow. All right. Well, I mean, if you want to look at it with an open mind, just made up on it. You know, that's cool.
No, I have an open mind. As soon as you demonstrate the possibility of something, then it is possible. But I'm not just going to say that anything is possible. Like, for instance, a cow jumping over the moon is not freaking possible. It literally cannot happen. A cow can't jump from the Earth into a lunar orbit and jump over the moon. That just can't happen.
Wait, hold on a second. I got to look at that from G-Man's perspective. It was prophesized that the cow may have jumped over the moon. Sorry. I had to be a dick. I'm sorry.
You succeeded.
Yeah.
You also cannot fly a winged horse through space and split the moon in two. That did not happen either.
But that's Muslim bullshit.
I ain't got nothing against Muslims. I just got nothing against
Muslims.
Or the unicorn or dragon. No signs of those ever existing.
No, unicorns exist. That's a fact. They're single horned rhinos.
Goats.
Well, no. The Latin name for a rhino is like I forget exactly what it is, but it's a two horn, like a unicorn, but it's a two horn thing, and the single horn version is a unicorn. It's just a mistranslation. People add shit on that didn't belong in the first place.
Yeah.
That doesn't his ignorance and his belief in a god does not make a god real. other physicists that believe in God today, their belief in God does not make God real. What matters is what you can prove, what you can show. And to this day, no one can show that there actually is a God. So it doesn't matter what they believe. It only matters what can be shown. If we want to go for an argument from popularity here, which is a very terrible fallacy, but 97 or 98%, no, I'm thinking of evolution. I think the vast majority of scientists do believe that there is no God, but it doesn't matter if that's true.
That's not true. Perfectly fine.
Faith is little more than an equivocation tool. It is almost. Wolfie, you guys ain't gonna believe this, but me and Gary are actually on the same panel. I was challenged to go to a panel tonight in OG's room, and then while me and OG were talking, Gary came on. And as you can see, there's the two of us together right now, having a good time, getting along, being civil with one another. We're on the same panel, so come on over. Get over to OG's New World Order right now. We need to fill this room to the gills, okay? So get on over here, guys. Get on over. All right? Come on over. But yeah, something you thought would never... I never thought in a million years this would happen. Me and Gary on the same panel, people. Come on over. Come on over.
I know you don't like humor, right?
Whoa.
Yeah. Canadians get crazy, huh? Fucking dogs.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck? Wow.
All eyes on me.
That's Tupac.
Yeah.
That's Snoop Dogg.
But, yeah, I can't believe this is the first time you guys have been on panel again. I thought you guys have talked before.
You didn't think Ottawa Valley?
Ottawa Valley Chronicles.
Ottawa Valley.
I want to thank you again for that, man.
No, I've never spoken to Emo, and he's never spoken to me. I mean, we've just been joking around with him. I mean, I hope he, I know you don't think it's that way, Emo, but it's all bad. I don't hate you in any shape or form. You're one of the funniest people I've ever met in my life. And everybody else feels the same way about you. We all love you, man.
I know, but when you cut up every video, it's like, oh my God.
I know. But, you know, Emo, I've done over 100 of Chip Folin. I do everyone else. You know, it's not like if I singled you out, you know, and just did all of you all the time, I've just done a bunch of videos and none of them had to do with you. So, I mean, it's not all you. You just gotta, you're taking it the wrong way. You know, I'm not meaning to attack you. You're just so funny, dude. You don't realize how funny you are, you know? I know you don't like humor. I know that you don't like my humor, and, you know, whatever it is. But you are a really funny person, and you could have a million subscribers if you set your mind to it. Because I've seen a lot of people on here, and they're way funnier than you and I. So, you're really funny. So, but I don't mean any harm towards you or anything like that. So, I know you take it that way sometimes, but that's not my intention. My intention is to make people laugh. We have enough bullshit in our lives and in the world to last us all for a lifetime. So, we can have a few laughs, whether it's at your expense, my expense, or anyone else's. You know. It's a good thing.
Yeah, because I know you've been trying to get on the panel with me and talk about this, and I've just been avoiding you until now.
Well, I mean, that's fine. I understand that you're upset. Some people, when they first see a video I make of them, like Bill Norwood, I just made 1M. You know, I figured he'd be like, oh, you son of a bitch. But he liked it, so it was like, you know, his mother yelling at him or whatever. But, but see, everybody does something funny. And I have that kind of personality where when I hear people say something, it's funny.
Yeah.
And I just, that's what I do. You know, he says, you know what, Gary? He goes, I looked on Google and stuff. He says, nobody ever does the videos that you do. Nobody does what you do. And I, you know, a lot of people would like to do what I do or whatever, but I tell people, be yourself. Emo is himself, right? And he makes you guys laugh. How fucking hard. So fucking hard. But he's funny. He doesn't realize that how funny he really is. You know, like, I don't always realize how funny I am. I laugh at my videos, but when some people say, boy, Gary, that was a good one, you know? It's like a surprise to me. It is, you know?
Yeah.
We're all good at what we do. Well, we're all gonna live on this fucking planet together, let's face it. I mean, we can all fuck each other and bash the shit out of each other and be mean to each other, or we can laugh with each other. You know, make somebody's day, you know what I mean? You get up a couple of towels, right? No, dude, you said to me, oh, I was having a really shitty day. That video was really funny. I think it was the family or what the fuck it was. I don't remember, but.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I love that stuff, man.
Yeah, he's like, you made my day, dude. And it's like, see, if one person laughs, that's what I did. I don't care about subscribers or likes or dislikes. I can fuck rat ass about that shit. I do it to make myself laugh, too. I have to live on a shitty planet with the rest of you, so.
Yeah.
Well, we got a lot.
You got it.
Yeah. Says, where's his video? And you should be a clown at a nursing home.
Yeah, I will be, because I'm old, so, you know. I won't be wrong, you know. I'll be there in a diaper, fucking sitting in a wheelchair, telling jokes, making fun of people, doing something. I guarantee you that.
Doing puppets instead of videos.
Yeah. By then, I want all my hair, my teeth. And I won't give a fuck if you guys see what I look like.
Yeah.
No, but there is one Gary video that I told him one time before in Too Tall Rob's room that there was one video that I did kind of like, and that was the one with the good, the bad, and the ugly type of thing with the Clint Eastwood one, where he did seven voices in it. And Gary said that was the hardest one to make because you're editing seven different audio tracks and all that.
That one
was great, you know.
I appreciate that, Emo. I appreciate that. It was hard because when I have to make like the family, when I make Emo's head talk on the wall and I make the father talk,
I love that one.
And now I have the mother talking now, you know, and I got Gary in the picture behind with the elephant gun, you know. It takes a lot of work to do something like that, you know.
Yeah.
But I do it to make people laugh. I've never done a video to hurt anybody, ever. I've never done that, and I never will do that. Like, I have people say, oh, you should get this guy, he's an asshole. I'm not the personal assassin. I'm not here to help you, you know, make somebody feel like a piece of shit, you know.
Yeah.
That's not my job. My job is I make myself laugh, and if I make any of you crazy bastards laugh in the process, I'm a happy guy, you know? Mm-hmm. No, I make Golden Eyes laugh and face hurts all the time.
Yeah, you do.
No, but the only ones I found were annoying were the diaper ones, over and over and over again.
But you know, Emo, just the picture of it made me laugh, okay? I mean, I know it didn't make you laugh, but it made me laugh, and I said, this is real. And I put Chip Poland in a diaper. I even put myself in a diaper, you know? In one of the videos, Emo Come Back, right? I put myself in a diaper. I think it was Emo Come Back or something like that. But I was standing in Speedos with you. I put myself in there. I can laugh at myself.
I laugh at myself all the time. I do stupid shit all the time.
I laugh at myself every time I'm shaving. Are you kidding me?
Did you find your glasses yet? Oh, God. Yeah.
Hey, Gary Snowflake. Somebody wants a shout out.
Who wants a shout out?
Trump tired.
I don't even know. I don't even know who that is.
Servitude.
Yeah, I don't know who that is. So.
I've seen him around. I don't know who he is though.
Somebody Trumps out there. Trump fraud. Whatever. Yeah, they all want to be my friend and stuff. I'm like, yeah, okay. One Trump in my life is enough.
Right.
Yeah, I'm good with that. Okay, you don't know who they are, man. They could, like, I mean, like Emo, he's got those fake Emos going around, you know? And
oh, God, we know who that is now.
Yeah, well, it ain't me. Emo, I can tell you right now, Emo, I don't do shit like that. I don't dox people. I don't flag. I'm not a flag fag. I don't flag people. I don't fucking copyright strike people. You know, people like me who do parodies of people, you have a responsibility if you want to call it. But you have a responsibility to community not to do that to someone else. If somebody does a video of me, I'm not going to flag them or copy strike. Right. I'm going to just give them a thumbs down and walk away, you know, or whatever, you know. You don't have to be mean like that.
This is true.
Like I said, there's a great book of Gary Snowflake. You guys should read through the pages. There's a lot of funny stuff in there.
So when is this? When are we going to be able to buy it on Amazon?
Yeah, I know. I should. Well, I was going to, Emo, I don't know if you noticed a couple of your videos. I put the Gary Snowflake on the wall behind you.
Yeah, on the clock, I believe.
I put the clock behind you. I was going to actually send one of those to you, Emo, but I felt as though you would have took a hammer to it or something, you know, on video.
That would have been a good video.
That would have been pretty cool, man.
It would have saved me from editing later.
Right, yeah.
Hema could make a video and smashing it to bits outside with a sledgehammer.
Right, yeah.
You know, I could see you two getting together and doing something really good together.
Oh my god, yes.
Absolutely. You know, with my brains...
intelligent people.
Hey, with my brains and Emo Savvy, we'll become millionaires. We'll rule the world.
Hey, Asperia News Service. How's it going?
Snowflake. Hey, Asperia.
2020.
Ah, damn, Asperia. But,
can you imagine? Emo Snowflake 2020. You guys can...
Well, it is 2020.
Let's make YouTube great again. Let's make YouTube great again. Emo and Gary Snowflake. We're running for office. That's our campaign slogan. Gary Snowflake and Emo Howling Wolf. Let's make YouTube great again.
Right?
Yeah, I think we could do something good together.
It's fucking hurting right now, you two. Let's just say that. We need something.
There's a lot of funny people on YouTube. I mean, you know, Emo he's fucking hysterical and hands down. And anybody that doesn't think so is an idiot.
Yeah. Okay?
But there are funny people. I mean, they just don't realize how funny they are. And I see him, I talk to him, I listen to him, and, you know, and it's like, oh, like, there's a video, you know.
Yeah.
Like the targeted citizen with the dinner party, and when I heard him talking, I'm like, oh yeah, this is gonna be, you know. But they're the ones that say it. They're the ones that say what they say. They're the ones that do what they do. It's not, I'm not making anything up. They're saying and doing these things, so
yeah.
Hey, why not touch on it if it's funny, you know?
Yeah.
Hey Emo, did you ever put those little black dicks on your car tires?
What?
No, I still have them.
Do you really? Okay, those have become like really, they're a fad now. Like everybody has to have them now.
Dude, you started something.
Yeah, everybody's rolling around with little dicks on their tires.
The little black cocks. And the way you were laughing, sitting back in your chair laughing, it was priceless.
Oh.
And that was you. That wasn't, I had nothing to do with that. That was you. That's what I'm saying, how funny you are, you know?
How do I get a couple of these? I gotta put them on Big Mama's car.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
So funny.
Well, women don't usually check the air in their tires or the oil or anything. You know?
No.
It blows up down the road, and it's like, oh, I don't know what happened. I put gas in it.
I don't do that, by the way.
What, you don't put gas in your car?
No, I don't do that. I don't just roll around.
Oh my god. He had to fucking mute his bike. He had to mute his fucking bike.
You know, people do that shit. They just gas and go and think that's all they need to do. It's like, no. No, I'm very particular.
Yeah. Gary had to mute his mic because he's a sour.
This bottle of water should work.
Plus, if you have a newer vehicle, you have sensors, and it'll tell you if you're low in the in one of your tires or in any of them.
Yeah. My vehicle shows you what tire is low and how much it.
Yeah, like what the poundage is or whatever. Yeah, that's what mine does too.
Check out Zebra, 80s rock band.
Zebra. Okay. Check out Zebra.
Zebra.
Oh my God,
it's an actual thing. Canadian. It's Zebra. Or Zebra.
Okay. God, I don't know if I've heard of them or not. I'm gonna have to.
Zebra was a good band back in the 80s.
Was it?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Maybe they had like a one hit. I don't remember them.
Uh oh.
Well, you've been smoking a lot of weed lately, dear. You know, you're lucky if you can remember yesterday. You know, the Canadians sending you all that bacon. Jesus Christ, you know?
Oh, God, right?
You find time for anybody on here.
You're bacon
Canadians.
You know, when you put your makeup on, it's really not right, even though you think it is. I mean, people have been talking. I ain't really saying, want to say anything, be the one to say anything. You're getting heavy on the mascara, hon.
I don't wear mascara, actually.
I want to put some light bulbs in the bathroom. See the light
bulb. I have lashes. I don't wear mascara. I have lashes.
How about the eyebrows? Has anybody tattooed their eyebrows on?
No, I would never do that.
No?
Now, Golden Eyes, don't lie. Are you one of those ladies that do the tattoo eyelashes under the eye? So
no way.
Oh, you didn't do that yet?
No, I won't ever do that.
Oh, you're still young. Yeah, you'll do it. You'll do it.
One thing, no.
Yeah, you will eventually. One day, too hard to do it.
No.
You know, once you start rubbing bacon grease on your face, the next thing is the eyes. That's it. I'm telling you. Canadians are fucking corrupting the shit out of you. You know,
oh, God. Shit. Tank was putting, what was that stuff? Ball
bead after
on
bead.
On his lips.
Bead after bead. Another Fetigran fleet is another one that sounds like that.
I didn't know that's what it was. It took a trapper that came in to tell me that Castro shit actually meant beaver balls, not the bean.
You ever wonder why?
Beaver ball aspect on my face.
I'm fucking Canadians, I'm telling you, they put beaver ball juice on their lips.
What Canadians have you been talking to?
I'll
be honest.
Was that you, Tank, that was saying that?
Yeah, I didn't know that that's what it was made of.
You were putting some beaver juice on your fucking mouth?
Yeah, there's two types of castrels. There's castrels.
Remind me not to kiss you, but.
There's beaver balls. Well, the stuff that I was using was made from beaver balls. And I was putting it on my fucking face and my lips and fucking shit, and I didn't know that's what it was until the trapper told me. He was like, that's what that shit's made of. I was like, no way.
He's like, wow, this is some good shit, man. This is some good shit.
That gives teabagging a whole new word. Whole new meaning.
Oh my goodness, you had to bring up teabagging.
Beaver tagging.
Beaver bagging. Oh God. That was so funny when he told me that. I was like, are you serious?
Did you guys, Golden Eyes, you ever wonder why Asian people, when they come from the Philippines or other places, they always move to Canada? You ever wonder why? Bacon grease.
Oh,
that's what it is. It's all in the fucking bacon up there.
Hold on a second. Has anybody heard of gutter oil?
No.
Bacon grease.
You don't eat the noodles on the street because they get the fucking the shit out of the sewer and then they boil it down and they use the grease from that and that's how they make their noodles. I'm not even joking. That's 100% real. Ari Shafir went through that shit.
I heard Canadians cut their fucking honey.
Do they?
Yeah, like they cut cocaine, they cut fucking honey up there. And then they ship it to the fucking United States. Oh yeah. Maple syrup too, they cut the fucking maple syrup. Oh yeah. Fucking big fucking business up there.
Oh my god. They cut their honey and maple syrup.
They do.
That's hilarious.
Drug dealers up there. They know what we fucking like. Hey, so let's send some bacon. All right. Only half the fat. Okay, got it, Bobby. Got it.
Bobby Bacala. They gotta work.
Oh, god. So what's the difference between regular bacon and Canadian bacon?
Well, Canadian bacon's real bacon.
Why? Because
no, I'm just joking. Actually, it's half of it is fake meat, and the other half is real meat.
I cut it.
And I'd like to say that's a joke, but it's not.
Oh no!
Our meat is half and half. We have half fake meat that they want to grow at some lab, and then they got actual cow, and they mix it together.
I'll tell you what the difference is right now, okay? You never see swamp hogs in Canada. They all live in the United States and other parts of the world. You never see swamp hogs in Canada.
Hey, Anon, how's it going, brother?
Hey,
thank
Anon.
You for being in here. That's cool, man. Everybody hit the like button.
Very really, come on. John Candy was about the only fat Canadian I ever seen in my life. But come on, they're really not fat people. They're really not fat people. Not like the
really?
United States. Not like the United States, they're
what?
Not.
Where's the
fucking snow? These people gotta go down the street for a fucking donut. They gotta drive in their minivan. At least you guys go through the fucking snow with those snowshoes and all that fucking Canadian bullshit you guys wear, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, at least you guys make an effort, you know?
Oh, God.
Yeah, but look at America. You're going to get out in that. You know what happened? I don't know if you Canadians are aware of this. In America now, McDonald's fucking delivers. These fucking swamp hogs don't even have to get in their minivan anymore and drive to McDonald's. They can sit in their fucking house and order up as much as they want in that fucking Grub fucking app or the.
Yeah.
They fucking bring it right to their fucking house now.
Yeah.
Are you talking about Postmates?
No, this is McDonald's.
Oh, McDonald's, they definitely deliver the
Pizza Hut, you name it, man.
Yeah, they deliver right to your door.
They'll deliver the shit right to your door now. It used to be just the pizza guy or the Chinese food. Now it's fucking McDonald's, Subway, fuck whatever you want, they'll fucking bring it to your house now. These swamp hogs don't even have to get in the minivan anymore.
Oh no.
You ever see him go to McDonald's and get like 8 double cheeseburgers and a large fucking I don't know who made these fucking soda cups up. These things are as big as my leg, right?
Oh my goodness.
It's always diet. It's always
regulators
diet.
Here.
It's always
How's
diet.
It going, regulator?
Take a bite, the one bite is like half the sandwich. I can't watch people eat like that. It grosses me out.
It's nasty. It is nasty. When you're in Walmart and you're behind them and they all get their swamp stain down their back and ass from being in the minivan. Oh, yeah, it's a nice fucking thing to follow down an aisle, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
I can't sit there and not say anything. I have to be rude. I just have to. I don't know. It's me. Like the ones that are riding around the electric carts, you know? And it's made for handicapped people, not fat people. That's for handicapped people, not fat people. Get your money out fucking business. Yeah.
You just made me spit my water on my dog.
The dog's like, what the fuck?
I'll tell you what, guys. Look it up. Look it up on Amazon, right? On Amazon, they have this shit called liquid ass, right?
Oh, my
and it
God.
Comes in a spray bottle. And I go to Walmart and other places, I bring it with me. And when I see one of those fatties in the fucking chair, going around fucking Walmart, I hit them with it.
You're an asshole.
Oh no.
And then I tell him, I say, those are for handicapped people. You know, not fat people. And they say, go fuck yourself, mind your own business. And meanwhile, they're off and running in their electric car, going up and down all these aisles, smelling like liquid ass. Everybody's fucking running away. It's the funniest shit you ever seen in your life.
Why don't you take a video, goddammit?
Dude, fucking, yeah, Walmart, they'll fuck, they'll have a Walmart will have you arrested if that they fucking assault, catch you doing that shit, you know?
Yeah. Just like DSS.
Well, you know.
DSS going to Walmart.
Hey. When I'm feeling sad inside and I'm not doing an emo video or something else like that, that's what I do. I go to Walmart or I go to social services. That's a good place. You know, social services, they're all in their pajamas, getting their welfare. You hit the elevator with it. Fucking watch the fireworks.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
Canada has free healthcare.
It is not free. One second. No, we do not have free healthcare.
Okay, serious.
Anybody that thinks we have free healthcare is part of the liberal side of the family, and we kind of ignore them a bit. But no, it is not free.
Wow, that went left really quick.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We had to bring it back on the topic
here.
I had to
bring it back there for a second, okay?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Okay. You know what? Americans talk a lot of shit about a lot of people. I'm an American. I know this firsthand. They always bitch about Canada. Canada has never done anything to the United States other than they almost burnt the White House down back in the day. They almost succeeded. You know, pretty much got all of it, but... You know,
we made up, though.
But they always bitch about everybody. All these Laotians, they come to the country, they get Trans Ams, they get three fucking S. They're so full of shit. They're so full of shit, their eyes are brown, man.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Do we have a word from you on how you think? What do you think about Canadians, Emo? You think they're nice people, or we should kill them all?
I haven't had no problems with any Canadians.
Yeah, you live closer to the Canadians than we do, Emo. So, if anybody would know about you sneaky Canadians, it would be Emo, right?
Are there homeless in Canada? There's lots of homeless in Canada, and another sad thing that there's veterans that are homeless in Canada, which that should not be. All veterans should be taken care of.
Shardy!
Hey, Shardy, what's going on, man?
Shardy, how are you tonight?
But anyway, one thing that you said about the homeless and stuff, I know you got a homeless problem in Canada. We do here in the United States. One of my issues with it is that we keep giving all these people from other countries sanctuary, you know, sanctuary city here, sanctuary city there. But yet, a lot of our veterans who fought for this country, right?
Amen.
Right, are living on the friggin' street, and we're not doing a goddamn thing to help them, and that pisses me off. That we're not
and are mentally
care of our own people first, and then the outsiders coming in.
Everybody, everybody on the street should have a home. Everybody should have help.
Tell you what, if you're fucking homeless in Canada, that sucks because you're gonna freeze your fucking balls off. It's fucking cold.
Right?
People have. I've seen people with shopping carts with two garbage cans, and that's what they light their fires for the night under the bridge.
Aww.
Yeah.
The sad thing is the money is there. The money is there. It's just being allocated elsewhere.
You know what the thing is?
They're helping the most evilest people at this time of life. And they're giving, looking at the homeless people and giving them the finger.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, you know what it is. Like, gee, he's got that fucking big house he lives in. He's got all that money. Remember when Tank Boy had that funny little drinking problem? He needed a place to fucking stay, and G was like, fuck you, okay? You know what I mean? Yeah, it's people like that.
What the fuck?
But,
I know, G, I promise I wouldn't mention that. I'm sorry, but, you know. Fucking Tank Boy was going to a fucking big thing back then. Booked on his horse big time. And I hear tale, at least it's the rumor I'm spreading, that you got him hooked on that shit.
Hey, I look at Mexico as North America. We should all have the right of travel. We're all in North America. But yet, after 9/11, they fucked us.
Aren't most of our immigrants coming from Syria right now?
Yeah, but that's how they're coming in. But true people from North America should be able to travel.
Well, it's as large as U.S. immigration. It's from India and China.
South America, too. So we're all one giant continent, so we should be able to travel around as we please. All of us. The whole continent.
You guys have a lot of Syrian refugees, same as Canada that come in.
Yeah,
we have a lot of Syrians, and we have a lot of, not Colombia, but what's the other South American shit? So we were talking about it a couple of weeks ago. There's a lot of gang war that's going on. Excuse me. And people are just, they're trying to escape because they don't, you know, they don't want to die. But the problem is that they're not just women and children, they're men that are known gang members, and they're fleeing because they're murderers, and now they're fearing retaliation, and they don't want to die, so they want to come here and take sanctuary.
The only ones I have a problem with are the fucking aliens, the real fucking aliens. The ones sneak down in the middle of the night, they abduct you, they fucking probe you. That's bullshit, guys. You know, that's fucking bullshit.
They're the ones you'd be scared of.
Yeah.
Oh God. I'm not even gonna go there.
I want to go back to our homeless for a second. The immigrant situation. Come off your paycheck. Then you get taxed for gas, then you get taxed for everything else you fucking buy. So with all those taxes they're taking, you're telling me you can't at least help the fucking veterans? You know?
There's also hidden tax in there as well.
Yeah, so why can't you fucking help these people instead of taking this money and stuffing it in their own pockets? Like,
because everybody has the same mindset, it's not my problem.
But that's not what's going on. If you look all around the world, the same thing is happening all around the world.
Yeah.
Exactly,
and
people
and
have this mindset.
When you say the ones that are causing it.
When you say, okay, take care of our own first, okay, you want to take care of our own first, why don't we take care of the Native Americans first before we take care of white people, black people, or anybody else?
Well, that's what I've included them in.
Everybody.
Those old color people, those are the people that originated.
But that's everybody. I don't look at people's colors, and we should all have what they're all fighting for. We all should have the same rights and the same food, the same everything.
In the reserve.
The Indians don't. The Indians get fucked. Yeah. They got fucked right from the start. The federal laws against them. They got fucking plantations, if you want to call them that. This is where you stay.
The reservations,
It's
shitty land, by the way.
That's why you don't really need government.
You know? And it's unfair. It's unfair that those people were the ones here. And everybody's like, oh, I wish these people would speak our language when they come here. I love that when they say that. I say, why don't you learn how to speak Apache or Navajo or Blackfoot? Because that's the fucking language that was here, not English, you know? I love that when people say that to me. I like to shove it right up their ass.
Yeah. Well, that's when they get the, if you go to any of these reservations, they have the shittiest land that was allocated to them.
They
can't do anything on it, except now, just recently, in the past 20 years, they've gotten into the casino business. And that's how their reservations are making revenue now.
You want to hear what ours looks like? When you go down, you see the smoke shops, okay? And you see the nice buildings, you see those farms?
Yeah, go down Wayne Gretzky's Parkway and make a fucking wrong turn. And then you see about the rest of them with all their cars broken down, no holes in their windows, all their doors smashed in. This is the worst of the worst land, isn't even how to put it. They were fucking sold out.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And that's what pisses me off when people say, "Why don't these people?" Like I was in the supermarket one day, and these two Spanish ladies are having a conversation, and this white fat old swamp hog lady leans over to me, thinking I'm a fucking racist like her. Says, "Why don't these people learn the fucking language?" I go, "What the fucking language? They're having a private conversation." They know Spanish. You can only speak barely English.
And she was standing there, like, just being, you know, like, just treating the clerk like shit.
No, I never used to.
Treating the clerk like shit, like, you know what, bitch, you know, calling her a bitch and saying that I'm not going anywhere until I get, because I guess her ID was, she was in line, I was in line, and she was trying to get some money, I guess, from Western Union. Her ID wasn't valid, and you need a valid ID, apparently, to do that. Well, she was bitching a high heaven about, bitch, you need to take care of, you need your fucking job, and blah, blah, blah. She was just berating this woman. And I was like, what the fuck? I go, you know, go get a goddamn ID and then you can, or get somebody to come here. She's trying to tell her. The lady was really nice. She was being very patient with her. And I'm like, can anybody else accept it? And I was like, can anybody else come and get this money for her? We'll have to go change the name. All right, lady, go call whoever sent you cash and get the name changed on it. And yeah, somebody make sure that they have an ID. Yeah, that's bullshit. You don't treat people.
I would have fucking said so. Yeah. I never used to pick on fat people, and I swear to God, guys, I never did. I was in Walmart one day, there's a swamp hog in front of me, she's got fucking sweat stained down her ass and back, she smells like ass, EO, you fucking name it, right? This woman turns to me and says, you smell like cigarettes. I loaded up that shotgun two barrels, right between the eyes, right there in Walmart. But she didn't buy nothing, she left, don't worry, she left. And ever since then, I'm the same way.
I think Emo's trying to talk, I can barely hear you, Emo.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you gotta turn your mic up.
Hang on. I got my mic muted. I was trying to do something real quick. Give me a minute. I'll be back.
Okay, man.
There you go. That sounds better. But yeah, I couldn't believe that she said that to me. I fucking smell like cigarettes. Are you fucking kidding me? You smell like a fucking dumpster lady. Are you gonna fucking say that to me? I don't fucking think so.
Right? Ew.
They need somebody like me. I'm in the aisle one day and I hear this couple fighting, right? They're in the next aisle. I know that you fought them and this and that. And I'm like, oh, you're going to be kidding me. The kids in Walmart, right? And I say, I go out. I go, I can hear you. I can hear you. What do they do? They got to come around the corner. So now I can see what they look like. You know what I mean? I'm like, really? I needed the visual with the audio, right? Oh, they're fucking dumb. It's surrounded by stupid every day of your life. You know? I can't ignore it myself. You probably can. Some of you are polite people. I'm not a polite person. I'm just not in me.
You sound like a fun guy to drink with.
Oh, yeah, I'm fun to drink with. Absolutely. As long as you're buying, buddy.
Oh, my God. I'd pee my pants. Like, no way.
Pee your pants.
I would pee my pants. You know, like after you drink, well, me personally, I don't know about everybody, but when I'm drinking and I'm fine until I pee that first time and then I gotta pee like every 15 minutes thereafter. I couldn't be around somebody like Gary. I'd probably piss myself.
You know what? I drink coffee in the morning. I piss like a racehorse. When I'm drinking alcohol, I very rarely urinate. It's like my body knows, oh, no, we're not getting rid of this. Every alcohol is fucking absorbed, you know?
You're hoarding it, right?
I make people piss their pants or spit coffee through their nose.
Big Mama knows what I'm talking about.
You know, that's always a good thing.
Must be a woman thing.
Yeah, it must be. Because I'm telling you, it's like, mm-mm.
I don't know. A few of my buddies didn't make it to the bathroom watching some of my videos.
So, yeah, yesterday, this I wasn't even supposed to talk about this, but last night, there's a fellow creator, and I used to call myself a super fan. One, because I knew there was people in the chat screenshotting and shit, and I'm trying to troll from the background. So, like, I post things in people's Discords, and I'm just like, I tell the leakers and things to snapshot it. I just saw it had another hiccup. So, yeah, Heretic made this stream, and in this stream, in this stream he essentially leaks Nick Suter's DMs, and this is like a two-level thing I want to go into. I want to go into why and when I think it's acceptable to leak someone's DMs, and I'm having a problem, and why I wasn't happy with Heretic doing it, because... And like, even though I do kind of understand, I just spilled coffee, so yay. Even though I kind of do understand the point, I was supposed to check up on chat though, so let me do that. Let me get people check on the chat, because I don't do that. I just get carried away and keep talking. So I'll look for tags. You're welcome, Sarah. Obviously, I'll do that for you. It's no biggie. Okay. So yeah, that's where we are right now. I can see the little hiccups on the stream though. That's not something I'm happy with. I need to maybe check something. I hope this does not end my stream. Oh, bitch. I'm connected to my Wi-Fi. What is wrong? Do I need to call up myself? Are you dumb? Are you dumb? That should not be a problem. Okay, anyway. So yeah, you're all chatting amongst yourself. Let me move on to the next thing. So yeah, heretic. And when I got sent the video for reasons of my own that I'm not going to get into because there's no reason to drag everyone around for that. It's nothing. Anyway, but for reasons of my own, I already decided I wasn't going to watch Heretic's videos anymore. And he came onto my community tab and posted a link. And I'm fine with that. Some people are bitchy about that. Some people delete it. It's like, don't promote your stuff. Don't promote your stuff on your channel. And I'm kind of like, I don't really give a fuck. I'm like, my platform is kind of fine if you want to post your shit. As long as you're not... But, I had a hiccup again, I think. But, I'd already made the decision I wasn't watching the video, so I kind of politely, as polite as I am, told him I'm not watching your videos anymore, but I'll leave the link here. Zerzi's having a freak out, if you can hear it. And so yeah, and then I started kind of getting bombarded with links from all different sides of people, and I was just like, okay, I'm still not watching it. That's the thing, if people come at me every single which way, I won't watch it. I know you're trying to get my attention and there's something about that to me that's just like, no. Yeah, that's just what the situation's like for me. So I, when everyone was sending me the link, I was like, no, I'm anti-ordinary. I'll watch this shit when I choose, if I even choose to. But I woke up this morning in a spicy mood and I went onto Twitter. And I only ever check Twitter because I don't have a Twitter account, but I only ever check Twitter after I drop a video on someone or something because I want to see opinions and what people are saying and what's flying around. And I saw some tweets and shit from Nick that I didn't appreciate. And as you all know, if you saw my community tab, I made that known to him. And then me and Nick ended up having a chat. And that's how I actually found out Nick's DMs will eat. And so I watched the video and... How do I, like, okay, so let's get into, let me give you my opinions on the DMs and stuff, but let's go into why I wasn't cool with Heretic releasing those DMs, blah, blah, blah. Because we don't really have the context for their relationship, right? And I just think, like, unless there's an accusation being made against someone, like in my case, I release mixed DMs, and I'm going to explain why I understand, why I think I understand why people would do, why Heretic done it, but in my case, when I released mixed DMs, it was to defend myself against accusations. And I gave Nick the chance to defend me publicly against these accusations because they were on his behalf. These are his friends and he's letting them run their mouth. So I'm like, I gave you the chance. I need to defend myself publicly. I have accusations being made against me. And it's in that case, it's in those instances, someone's making false accusations or claims against you. I don't justify using, Thank you, £10 from Fallow Blue. I'm never going to learn your name, Blue, but thank you. I appreciate it. Number one fan. So anyway, where was I? I'm not going to remember to finish this sentence before I read those out. So yeah, it's in those instances. When you can demonstrate or prove and defend yourself against an accusation, then yeah, release the DMs. I wouldn't hold anything against you. But, shut up, Fiona. Okay, but, So, yeah, I wouldn't hold it against you, but in this case, it felt like to me it was more to demonstrate a point about Nick's character, right? Whether we agree with that point or not, it wasn't to defend anyone against any kind of claim against them. As far as I know, and if I'm wrong, correct me and I'll take that, but as far as I know, it wasn't a defensive releasing of DMs. It was, okay, we'll go into why I think it happened. I think because as a result of my video, I released everything. I wasn't hesitating, bitch. This was something that was important to me. And if you watched the video to the end, chills, you would have seen that. But, so I let everything out. And when I did that, it kind of snowballed because I think other people twigged on to the same kind of behavior that happened with me and between me and Nate, really. But between me and Nate and other people included in this story in the background. Thank you. Is that Canadian? I don't know. I'm a moron. But thank you for the $2 Canadian, if that's what it is. So I thank you for the $2 US, Noily. So I am. So I saw your message. I'm gonna go get back to the tags after this. I want to try to stay on track. Blah blah blah. What was I gonna say? And so when I was reading through the comments, I saw Ansgar Odison leave a comment. Oh no, bitch. If you know my history on this channel, I don't like Ansgar Odison. I haven't liked him for a long time. He's a grade A dickhead. But I see him in the Heretics comments of the video saying whatever he said. And people were defending it, saying that Nick was sharing, and he was. Nick was sharing the video around with lots of people privately. And it wasn't giving Mel a chance to defend herself, but it was making character assessments and claims about Mel. I was making claims about Mel based on that information, point blank period. And I still, that's the thing, a lot of people have come to me after my video, and that's the one confusing thing to everyone, is what happened to Nick? And I can't really say. I feel like that's a bit of me. That's why I didn't even say it in the video, because I feel like that's me overstepping. And a lot of people saw what I did already as overstepping. So I don't wanna go there. But whatever Nick presents in this video, this long ass hour something video, makes a really compelling case to me, at least. And I've heard some criticisms around the area that it's weird. Demi, you're a weirdo. They didn't say it to me, of course. People rarely actually give their criticism straight to me, even though I'm good at taking them. Anyway, it's like, oh, Demi, you're a weirdo. You had such an emotional response to Nick, but when you're talking about the rape apologies, literal fucking real physical rape and all kinds of horrible shit was going, we're going to go into that, but when you're talking about that, you're just very blasé and not in it, and there's a whole lot more to why that was the case, but this is the part relating to Nick. The reason I was more invested in the Nick situation is because, like, no one's ever actually come to me as a victim of all some horrible shit we've gone into. No one's ever actually come to me for help in these kinds of situations. So when Nick did, I first was really skeptical, but then when I agreed with him, like, I just went out of my way to help him. And then when that was thrown in my face after he literally told me I'd done perfectly, and that was all that made me really happy. I felt like the first time I'd helped someone hurting with something, like, I'd done good, but that didn't last. So because I just, like, it was just this weird kind of psychology. When I'm going to be looking at the, when I'm going to be, sorry, I just had like a little fangirl moment. So I saw Umanza in the thing, and we're gonna get to that. But when I talk about the rape apology shit, I'm still not going to be as emotional. I'm going to be fucking angry. Well, I guess that's emotional. Yeah, I'm going to be fucking angry. Spoiler alert. But I'm not going to be sad or those kinds of emotions like I was in my last video, because I was like emotionally connected to that shit, and it came to me as like a victim, and I was just, and I actually believe that stuff, and I still do based on the video. So yeah, that's just kind of where I stand. Okay, so Umanza just joined the stream. They're a fucking legendary egg. Z, I don't know, I was in a live stream and someone said Z's. I'm not sure if they're trolling or if that's a legitimate thing. Let me know, I'm not trying to be a bitch. Anyway, so I was on Discord yesterday. I don't have Twitter, got banned. Personally against terms of service, whatever the fuck. And someone posted a picture of Umansa's tweet. And Umansa tweeted out, I think it was a screenshot of a fundraiser for Steve, and it was to buy Steve McRae a hat, and the sum was like 19,000 or something. I'm leaving the hall. Red's rhetoric, funeral, debacle, bedroom situation, recording out of it, because, like, I only was doing that shit to defend Red. Like, let's be real, I was only doing it because I saw all this shit go down, and I'll go more in deep, like, how I got involved in everything. But, like, for this stream, I just saw shit go down, I saw Reds, and I kind of took pity on him. I was like, oh, you don't look like you're doing this. I just wanted to help him, and I did want to talk to everyone, because I didn't want to help a shit person. But I wasn't able to, and, like, now I have, why would I want to go out of my way to help Reds? Like, that's just not something I'm going to spend the effort of making a new video to really address. But, like, I really do have to readdress the rape apologetic shit, because I'm not happy, one, how I addressed it initially, but I'm also not happy just taking the video down and just hiding from it and not addressing how I fucked up. So I'm gonna do that. I don't really want to do it live, because that's not something I'm going to do good enough. So I'll save that for the video, but that's where I plan to go with that. Let me know your thoughts on that whole situation down below. If you don't know, for a little bit of background, Steve McRae hosted this convicted rapist on his channel, sent it to me. I think I'm having internet problems. Let me know in the chat if I'm having internet problems, because it's freaking out for me. But yeah, essentially, he decided to host this person. People were giving him criticism in the chat, and he was deleting it and blocking people and all that shit. And this led to a creator called Fiona Robertson making a video doing the whole situation. Now, when Fiona first made her video, I didn't watch it. I've watched it a couple of times now. But when she first made it, I didn't watch it because, honest piece of criticism, hi Fiona, I see you in the chat. Honest piece of criticism is, it just felt too heavy-handed and emotional for me. And when I clicked onto it and I realized it was gonna be one of those videos, I clicked straight off. So, that was my bad. But anyway, tangential, she made that video and everyone blew the fuck up. And then it was on Twitter, and yeah, that's pretty much a bit of the background. I'll give you a better one in the video, but that's where I'm gonna go with that. What's everyone's thoughts? Small hiccup every now and then. Yeah, I know. I don't know what's going on. Is it anything that's dramatically impacting the stream? Because that is annoying. Yeah, so let me, I'm so, hi Sarah, welcome. Welcome to the stream. Oh, Sarah's got a new video coming out soon, and it's relating to if you're a trans woman, or if you even just want to know, wait, how does a bitch tell a bitch about a bitch? If you want to know that stuff, go check out Sarah's channel. She's going to have a new video soon about, like, when trans people should tell their partners about dating. My mind is like, you should have, that bitch should know before you're even kissing them. And that's just my two cents. I don't know what Sarah's idea. I'm just not telling you what Sarah's opinion is, so go check that out. Yeah, so anyway, I need to get back on topic. So yeah, yesterday, I wasn't even supposed to talk about this, but last night, there's a fellow creator, I used to call myself a super fan. One, because I knew there was people in the chat screenshotting and shit. I'm trying to troll from the background. So like I post things in people's discords and I'm just like, I tell the leakers and things to snapshot it. I just saw it had another hiccup. So yeah, Heretic made this stream, and in this stream, In this stream, he essentially leaks Nick Suter's DMs, and this is like a level thing I want to go into. I want to go into why and when I think it's acceptable to leak someone's DMs, and I'm having a problem, and why I wasn't happy with Heretic doing it, because like, even though I do kind of understand, I just spilled coffee, so yay. Even though I kind of do understand the point, I was supposed to check up on chat though, so let me do that. Let me get people check on the chat, because I don't do that. I just get carried away and keep talking. So I'll look for tags. You're welcome, Sarah. Obviously, I'll do that for you. It's no biggie. That's where we are right now. I can see the little hiccups on the stream though. That's not something I'm happy with. I need to maybe check something. I hope this does not end my stream all bitch. I'm connected to my Wi-Fi. What is wrong? Do I need to call up my server? Are you dumb? That should not be a problem. Okay, anyway. So So yeah, you're all chatting amongst yourself. Let me move on to the next thing. So yeah, heretic. And when I got sent the video for reasons of my own that I'm not going to get into because there's no reason to drag everyone around for that. It's nothing. Anyway, but for reasons of my own, I already decided I wasn't going to watch Heretic's videos anymore. And, he came onto my community tab and posted a link, and I'm fine with that. Some people are bitchy about that. Some people delete it. It's like, don't promote your stuff. Don't promote your stuff on your channel. And I'm kind of like, I don't really give a fuck. I'm like, my platform and kind of fine if you want to post your shit. As long as you're not. But, I had a hiccup again, I think. But, I'd already made the decision I wasn't watching the video, so I kind of politely, as polite as I am, told him, I'm not watching your videos anymore, but I'll leave the link here. Zazie's having a freak out, if you can hear it. And, and so, yeah, and then I started kind of getting bombarded with links from all different sides of people, and I was just like, okay, I'm still not watching it. That's the thing. If people come at me every single which way, I won't watch it. I know you're trying to get my attention, and there's something about that to me that's just like, no. Yeah, that's just what the situation's like for me. So I when everyone was sending me the link, I was like, no, I'm anti-ordinary. I'll watch this shit when I choose, if I even choose to. But I woke up this morning in a spicy mood. And I went on to Twitter, and I only ever checked Twitter because I don't have a Twitter account, but I only ever checked Twitter after I drop a video on someone or something, because I want to see opinions and what people are saying and what's flying around. And I saw some tweets and shit from Nick that I didn't appreciate. And as you all know, if you saw my community tab, I made that known to him. And then me and Nick ended up having a chat. And that's how I actually found out Nick's DMs were leaked, and so I watched the video, and how do I, like, okay, so let me give you my opinions on the DMs and stuff, but let's go into why I wasn't cool with Heretic releasing those DMs, blah, blah, blah. We don't really have the context for their relationship, right? And I just think, like, unless there's an accusation being made against someone, like in my case, I released Nick's DMs. And I'm gonna explain why I understand, why I think I understand why people would do, why Heretic done it. But in my case, when I released DMs, it was to defend myself against accusations, and I gave Nick the chance to defend me publicly against these accusations because they were on his behalf. These are his friends and he's letting them run their mouth. So I'm like, I gave you the chance. I need to defend myself publicly. I have accusations being made against me. And it's in that case, it's in those instances when someone's making false accusations or claims against you, I don't justify using, thank you. £10 from Fallow Blue. I'm never gonna learn your name, Blue, but thank you. I appreciate it. Number one fan. So anyway. Where was I? I'm not gonna remember to finish this sentence before I read those out. So yes, in those instances, when you can demonstrate or prove and defend yourself against an accusation, then yeah. Release the DMs. I wouldn't hold anything against you. But, shut up, Fiona. Okay, but, yeah, I wouldn't hold it against you, but in this case, it felt like to me it was more to demonstrate a point about Nick's character, right? Whether we agree with that point or not, it wasn't to defend anyone against any kind of claim against them. There were, as far as I know, and if I'm wrong, correct me and I'll take that, but as far as I know, it wasn't a defensive releasing of DMs. It was, well, we'll go into why I think it happened. I think because as a result of my video, I released everything. I wasn't hesitating, bitch. This was something that was important to me. And if you watch the video to the end, Shills, you would have seen that. Let everything out, and when I did that, it kind of snowballed because I think other people twigged on to the same kind of behavior. that happened with me and between me and Knight, really. But between me and Knight and other people included in this story in the background. Thank you. Is that Canadian? I don't know. I'm a moron. But thank you for the $2 Canadian, if that's what it is. So I thank you for the $2 US, Miley. So I am. So I saw your message. I'm gonna go get back to the tags after this. I wanna try stay on track. Blah blah blah. What was I gonna say? And so when I was reading through the comments, I saw Ansgar Odison leave a comment. Oh, bitch. If you know my history on this channel, I don't like Ansgar Odison. I haven't liked him for a long time. He's a grade A dickhead. But I see him in Heretic's comments of the video. Saying whatever he said, and people were defending it, saying that Nick was sharing the video around with lots of people privately, and it wasn't giving Mel a chance to defend herself, but it was making character assessments and claims about Mel. I was making claims about Mel based on that information, point blank period. And I still, that's the thing, a lot of people have come to me after my video, and that's the one confusing thing to everyone. Is what happened to Nick? And I can't really say. I feel like that's a bit of me. That's why I didn't even say it in the video, because I feel like that's me overstepping. And a lot of people saw what I did already as overstepping. So I don't wanna go there. But whatever Nick presents in this video, this long ass hour something video, makes a really compelling case to me at least. And I've heard some criticisms around the area that it's weird, Demi, you're a weirdo. They didn't say it to me, of course. People rarely actually give their criticism straight to me, even though I'm good at taking them. Anyway, it's like, oh, Demi, you're a weirdo. You had such an emotional response to Nick, but when you're talking about the rape apologies, literal fucking real physical rape and all kinds of horrible shit we're going to go into that, but when you're talking about that, you're just very blasé and not in it, and there's a whole lot more to why that was the case, but this is the part relating to Nick. The reason I was more invested in the Nick situation is because, like, no one's ever actually come to me as a victim of all of the, some horrible shit we've gone into. No one's ever actually come to me for help in this, in these kinds of situations. So when Nick did, I first was really skeptical, but then when I agreed with him, like, I just went out of my way to help him. And then when that was thrown in my face after he literally told me I'd done perfectly, and that was what I, like, that made me really happy. I felt like the first time I'd helped someone hurting with something, like, I'd done good, but that didn't last. Because I just, like, it was just this weird kind of psychology. When I'm going to be looking at the, when I'm going to be, sorry, I just had, like, a little fangirl moment, so I saw Umancer in the thing, and we're going to get to that. But when I talk about the rape apology shit, I'm still not going to be as emotional. I'm going to...
Oh, shit.
They always ask me, they're like, Gary, where do you come up with this shit? I said, I don't. It's everybody else. It's all these people I meet on YouTube. I used to go all month for my shits and giggles. I just got to turn on the fucking computer and they're all there waiting for me.
Oh, good. There's all kinds of walks of life in Walmart, though.
Yeah. All the people, look at all the people that I've gotten, if you look at all my videos. There's something funny about every one of them. Every one of them. Not just Emo. I mean, Emo, he's hysterical. But there's something funny about every one of you. You just don't know it.
Oh, some of us know it. Absolutely. I just think as a woman...
Like, Gary, where do you come up with this shit? I said, I don't. It's hard
for me to see a woman not care about what she looks like when she walks out the front door.
We're going to have to save this woman talk for the woman show.
I know, but still. God. I saw that. I got to
think. Yeah, there should be a lot more. Well, if we had, like, a notice that... You know, Gary and Emo, first time ever up on panel. I mean, I think the whole YouTube community would be in that.
Maybe we can get A Balance to mirror on this.
Hold on,
just leave a teaser.
People retract them on their own. They don't.
If you're gonna stay in my room, please don't retract your message.
Okay. my spelling wasn't that good, so you know.
I think I love him more than all of you. What videos have you ever done of Emo, you selfish pricks?
Don't
be late for me, because I got to lose some weight. You know, you're doctor. You said I got to lose some weight. I'm getting a little bit in the ass, so don't like me about that either, you know? I'm a little obsessed with that, too. You don't get me killed, so. Hey, don't come back. Please don't do it too, man, you know? Don't keep looking at my lazy tongue, man.
No.
Yes, man. You can probably get me some kid. All right. We'll see you guys.
See, I get everybody. I don't discriminate. I'm an equal opportunity asshole.
You know my favorites lately have been the black Jesus. Too tall, step back for a little bit and let you come.
How you doing? How you doing?
How you doing?
Oh no, your voice is still out.
Can I see your picture so I can know it's the real emo?
Yes, Rob, for you. Yes.
Hang on. Oh yeah, you do with the Rob.
Emo, I wanna apologize, but my issue with my live stream was the RAM, not to bringing it down to 144. Drop by on your way over Jackson for some brownies and ice cream. What happened?
The route that I went never took me towards your house. It never took me into that state.
Well, that was your mistake, not mine. You were invited.
I don't know if I'd go to your house, Rob. You scare me sometimes, dude. With all those guns and shit you've been hiding in the background next to the fishing poles, I know they're there.
Well, the other thing about the Texas trip is because I know Gary was putting out videos and a few people didn't think I was going to go, so I was trying to be sneaky about it. I was trying to sneak down there without anybody knowing it. I was going to just show up down there. But on the way down, I let Carolina and Fort Worth know, and of course, she went and told everybody.
I always knew him. I'm always watching. I knew.
I tell you what, Emo, we had $1,000 out there for you to come on the show, and we waited about 3 hours. This was before you went. I don't know what the fuck happened, but I know that you got flooded. We were going to try to squash some shit and put it to bed about some of the miscommunication. We have a pay pool plan going. We're raising money for the bucket list for the snowflake. We're going to take him shark diving with the sharks in the South Pacific.
You guys
little- see my cop watching video last night when I was live streaming about the pizza, and I audited the pizza, and the cops had come to get the pizza and everything, and then I went to get the pizza, and it was a wonderful day for pizza. But
no, I missed that one, Rob.
Need to make out.
I put in the first order for the little black cock.
You what?
Yeah, he's gonna say
little monkey.
At the room count, I'm like, there's only 7 or 8 people in here. We gotta change this. We gotta get the word out. Like, that the breaking news is happening on YouTube. So that's why I made the video. I knew that was good.
The bird just kept stabbing me in the back. I thought we were friends.
What's up, Emo? Gary. How you guys doing? This is epic.
I was just informing Emo that the orange is the new black. Let him know about that printer business you got going on.
Yes. So let me just say that this is awesome to see the two of you together, and I think that you guys are going to make beautiful YouTube magic. In the meantime, here's a couple of thoughts. You guys might want to do something together on Teresa R, maybe.
Oh.
So when you throw that out, get all like, copyright strike, copyright strike.
Copyright strike.
Right? Like, it'll be awesome. Oh, Emo left.
Where'd he go? No, he had a problem earlier. I think he'll be back.
Yeah, he was mad at the bird.
No, he just got kicked. He'll come back.
Larry Bird, how you doing, huh?
I'm doing filament, so we're ready to rock and roll. Just download the 3D image that you want to make and bam. So, yeah, we need to get some money going together for that for a quick display of our love towards Emo and what he does. So, you know, people,
cool.
We're shipping and handling. All I need is a little shipping and handling. Emo's back.
Yeah, so you're unblocked now. I had to unblock everybody. There was like 10 people I blocked because they were hanging out with Gary, but now that I'm hanging out with Gary, it's not fair to keep
them. Oh, it's okay, guys. Nice.
Yeah, yeah, I unblocked everybody.
Cool. Yeah. It's good to see you.
They're not on the hit list anymore, huh?
Hey, it's nice to know I was at the top of the list, you know. I felt loved, brother. I did. You can hang out with me anytime, you know, anytime.
Yeah.
And he just got turned around. I forgot which one it was in. So by the time he got there, he got a ticket. But
Black,
they didn't tow it.
Black Jesus helped him find it. Black Jesus helped him find it.
I thought Joku just lost his car again.
What? Well, I seen
no,
Rick
no, I'm just joking, but everybody wants to know why Joku lost his car.
I saw a Rick Crude video about somebody losing their car, but I... Yeah, Rob's determined to get that car.
Oh, yeah. He's mine. He's got it. He's got his filthy fingers into everything on fucking YouTube.
Look at that smile. He's like, yeah, I got 73% coming my way.
Fucking raw, man.
We're all speechless.
Oh, man.
I think we're that close that made it, right?
Look at that fucking bong. Jesus Christ.
That fucking bong is fucking intense. That fucking crazy shit.
Yeah, wow.
Go, bye. Yeah, they're going to Broadway for dinner and a play.
With your permission.
I was thinking maybe. You can be the plaintiff, I'll be the defendant, Emo, if you want. So we may, you know.
I think I'll pass on my 73% on that one.
We're gonna go blind.
We're gonna
steal money. Yeah, we can all smile about it.
You can laugh about it. Fuck it, you know?
Yep, absolutely. Check your mic, Gary.
Oh, having made like you, Liberty, pushing a fucking grocery cart in there for fucking 3 hours, fucking buying munchies.
Dude, you want to see what a man's pants looks like after work, dude?
Show me. Oh, that's hot.
You're wearing your best.
You not learn the joys of propane?
We got him up on a panel. You just gonna throw email that $1,000?
No, that offer's long gone.
Oh, boo. They didn't want your pizza.
No. I'm sitting there waiting on the pizza guy, right? And we're talking about pizza. And I get an anchor for some pizza, so I get a pizza. Yeah, a basic pizza. And I'm sitting there, I've got a fucking hot box that man all the hell. I'm sitting there. Two cops come rolling by, come into the store, walk right past my man, and get them two pieces of pizza, hop in the shit, and roll out. My first cop watching on it.
Jeez, yeah, I seen you with the roach clip. That's too good.
But hey, just a real quick, everybody, Emo, I want to introduce myself to you. Chad Aviator, I never met any Bill party man. I want to promote your channel, and yeah, man, this is me.
See, you know he's a compulsive fucking liar. We never believe a word the fucking kid
said. Yeah, what?
Good, Rob.
I remember Rob saying that during the stream too. Aviator's like, "What are you talking about?" And then he like goes and does some other stuff. And Rob's like, "I wasn't joking."
That off.
That was no joke, Bo.
Yep, no, yeah. Emo, I was 100% serious on that.
That was real deal dollars.
Serious on that.
I was so waiting for him to eat that money, man. I was like, oh, this is going to
be
like,
stab
you in the back, Aviator.
The only reason that Rob's saying anything is because it's 73%. That's the only reason he's saying anything.
Well, I'm just a little frustrated that I didn't get anything out of that second 73 was split up there to guarantee. I should have got 73% of that, too.
Go before Gary, then he gets your 73%.
That's right. His voice, he's feeling under the weather right now. I got a good fucking chance right now taking it back.
14 years, he's got left.
Yeah, well, not just that, but they're all like death by heights. It's just kind of funny because everybody picks a different way from like the fall out of the sky or a long walk off a short cliff or vice versa.
you forgot about swimming with the sharks in the South Pacific.
Yeah, there's some pretty inventive stuff, man. They really gave him a bucket list.
Thank you, buddy. You wanted to throw me out of an airplane, Mike.
Yeah, but I think what we're going to have to do is get a blowtorch. And the Emo commercial is going to be me and Emo clearing out a huge section of snow out of my front yard with a blowtorch. We'll call it Melting Snowflakes.
Oh. I like a shot.
I'd watch that. Fuck yeah. How'd it get you there, Gary?
Why not? Alright, guys.
Hey, speaking about Gary, I checked out one of your earlier videos at Eric Brandt where it was all like totally like his picture and his face moving. Oh man, killed me, dude. It was great. I think it was a mugshot.
Oh, the mugshot?
Yeah.
He's funny, though. He's a funny guy. I mean, you know, hi everyone, it's Crazy Eric. It's always fun doing that fucking voice. I don't know why, you know, but I got him in a bunch of videos.
It's just my epic. I think Gary doubled the subscribers.
Fuck yeah, you did.
I think Emo and Angry Grandpa are both skipping this anchor subscription medication.
I think everybody's been really waiting for this. Everybody's been really waiting for Emo and Gary to come together here.
Yeah, except for Emo and myself, right?
I'm glad it happened on my platform. That's good.
No, it's good look at the comedy, right?
Yeah.
The comedy behind it like brings us together and we can all laugh about it. We can laugh at ourselves and each other, you know?
Yeah.
You all do all the laughing you want, just don't forget my 73%.
Holy jeez. So we're going up.
Rob's getting all the money, man.
I got Rob with a few videos too. He laughs. I got Aviator. I get a lot of people, you know. Guys are all funny. Yeah. But eventually I'm gonna find something really funny about you and it's gonna click like Bill Norwood, it was coming. You know, I had to do it, you know. I mean, it was just inevitable it's gonna happen. So. Oh my god, she doesn't know who Bill is.
Bill is. Hold on a second. We're gonna. Is it okay if I play it?
Play it.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Man, so many dimensions.
There's old Billy.
Alright, Bill Norwood's house. Yeah. Have me some beers.
I want your horse.
The script he's laying around. I don't know. Crazy Bill, shit. I mean, that fucking mother might be a fucking song. I don't know. I'll bring my fucking horse in the house if I want to bring him in. Fuck you.
Don't you sass me.
Catch too.
Smack you in the mouth.
I remember watching one time one of them cats turned up in one of them boxes back there. That was hilarious.
Oh, you're making enough fucking money off everybody on here. Forget it, buddy.
Hey, can I ask a serious question, Emo? You mind?
Yeah, go ahead.
Like, how do you feel when you gotta go out on site with Monkey 83 and Not Now Maybe Later and them, dude? Like, LFA, right? All them dudes were there. Like, how did that go for you, man? Like, does it make you feel kind of like they weren't really, you know, paying attention that they had a great Emo fucking Justin Emo fucking Hollywood, dude? You know what I mean?
It was cool meeting them. I had no problem meeting them. The first time I was there,
it was not
I think there's no guys in that video. He says, "Please, guys, my dude, he doesn't fucking care."
North Dakota, huh?
Yep, way up there next to the fucking border.
Stuff area. Whatever you do, you're getting pilot license. Just don't pull over 2 gallons and a pilot license. Don't go up your pilot's license, and I know around that clearly Iowa area is where they crash, so.
Yeah, that's just a
back intro. Right.
Oh, you don't want to know.
Oh, you don't want to know.
It's a Luka glass, bro.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, this is the platinum one. Like, it's
like 300-400?
Yeah, it's just a little more than that, but not by much.
Okay.
All right, it's in the private chat. We're yelling at each other, I know.
No, absolutely. This is great.
We're on. When we're off, we're off, you know? We're like Abbott and Costello, you know?
Who the fuck is that?
It's good stuff, you know?
You don't know who Abbott and Costello is?
No, I have no culture.
Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on third. I was going to do me and Emo doing that bit. Here's the video.
Full screen.
Oh, shit. I don't even know how this is true, too. I don't know how to. Oh,
don't be so lazy, man. Don't be so lazy. Look for it.
Man,
there we go.
It is.
Oh my god.
Look at that Willie Nelson beard in the background.
Oh.
Sister Whiskers. Yes. Whisker Sisters.
Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Yeah. The CEO of YouTube. The internet was.
What the fuck are you about? I'm gonna hire all of you guys to get me.
Right. Next time, I hire my fucker to drive the Chevy. I was at the grocery store today, and you know that grocery store music, and that one song came back, Baby Come. And I'm sitting there to check out, Emo Come Back, You Can Blame It 73% on, and a girl's check out, like, what the fuck are you singing about? And like, I can't get that song out of my Emo Come Back, man. But Emo, I'm glad you're back, brother. We love you.
That's the greatest comment ever.
Okay, Frosty, I hear you. I see you. I see the comment.
Make me laugh, and that's what I'm going after.
And this is true. This is a true statement. Emo, you've helped more people than you will ever know, my brother or my friend. So it's true. That is true. You know.
Yep. Thanks, guys.
I'm just saying. Yeah. No. What's no flake? I got my 73% contract. You know, we can
do it.
Foreign policy. Something.
I'm out of weed right now, so you can just send that right over.
It's funny how me and Gary thought about that at the same time. I was about to say that same fucking thing. Where was OG's cut, huh?
Coming. I don't know how you get delivery in your car, but you know, Rob.
No,
I don't know. Maybe you just ducked out long enough to where I wasn't paying attention, but he slipped inside.
I was waiting on his call to go meet him at the Root Beer Float Shack.
My old lady's tires, it's gotta be red and black.
Don't we call them out tires? That what they call them up again in the tires?
Yeah.
Just waiting on his call to go meet him at the Root Beer Float Shack. Like, whoa.
Does anyone ever else, or anyone else ever kind of feel like Rob's talking like he's from fucking Mars?
Yeah,
like, what fucking plants are you growing?
All the fucking time, dude. It's like Charlie Brown's parents, huh?
Men are from Mars, women are from fucking Venus, and Robert's somewhere in between.
Yeah.
Is a bacon factory in Canada.
It's gonna be Tweed, man. Tweed, where they grow the Canadian fucking cannabis.
I didn't know you guys grew it up there. It was so fucking cold and shit.
Yeah, they grow it in the old chocolate factory. So it's kind of ironic how the old Munchie factory turns into the new weed factory.
I have a reserve in Brantford where they had marijuana fields, and I took a video on the reserve, and then I got out of there before.
I didn't think they grew weed up there in Canada. I really
didn't.
Yeah, maybe it's
Snoop Dogg. We're sponsored by Snoop Dogg.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg is responsible for all the additions done on the new factory. It's a massive fucking grow up that the government.
Yeah, you guys always
have his own brand too.
You guys always.
We have a special guest, Justin Emo.
A long time, man. Fucking snack packs.
Yeah.
You can't eat just one of them fucking things. It's too small. You gotta fucking.
Now, Big Mama, you're gonna have that doggy. Big Mama, you're gonna have to keep it down here, doggy style. You're gonna have to keep it. Okay, so you just gotta settle down.
Doggy style, whoa.
Yeah.
Canadians get crazy, huh? Fucking
dogs. Oh, yeah.
What the fuck? Wow.
All eyes on me.
That's Tupac.
Yeah.
Not Snoop Dogg.
But, yeah, I can't believe this is the first time you guys have been on Paleo. I thought you guys have talked before.
Anything, Ottawa Valley?
Ottawa Valley
Chronicles. Ottawa Valley.
I want to thank you again for that, man.
Now, I've never spoken to Emo, and he's never spoken to me. I mean, we just been
I've just been joking around with him. I mean, I hope he, I know you don't think that way, Emo, but Salt's bad. I don't hate you in any shape or form. You're one of the funniest people I've ever met in my life. And everybody else feels the same way about you. We all love you, man.
Which means we must follow.